Lane is crossing, not to bring it out, so Barco does his job well for the Seminoles, and Georgia goes on offense, first and 10 at the Bulldogs' 20-yard line. Georgia offense has scored only 43 points in the last four games. Bowden says the key to stopping Georgia is to stop the man on the right, the fullback, number 35. He's a good one, Andre Smith. Quarterback Todd Williams is a junior, his father quarterback Georgia. The receivers on the flanks are freshmen, Cassius Osborne and Jimmy Hockaday. They can get deep. Offensive line is big as we go to live action, and the Bulldogs go right to the run, and Florida State shuts it down quickly.
Stop by number 65, Darryl Gray.
Defensively, Florida State has some big people up front. Linebackers are good. Taylor, 58, is the key man to watch. He's the number one tackler, 58. Henry Taylor, the man off to the right. Fred Jones is the second leading tackler. The two inside linebackers really key to Florida State defense. After a gain of 3 yards on the play, Georgia looks to throw the ball. Williams gets it out, and Herman Archie comes down with a football, and the Bulldogs are ahead for a first down as he crosses the 30-yard line. 11-yard gain on the play. Defensively, the front line for Florida State. And left there, 45, Isaac Williams is a big play man. Stroud and Nichols, big down linemen. And then those linebackers who are so strong. Henry Taylor, the guy to watch. Back to live action and a stuff at the line of scrimmage. Fred Jones comes in and makes the hit on a freshman tailback, Cleveland Gary, who carried the ball for Georgia on first down and got nowhere. Trump, the secondary of FSU, has been a problem, as Bobby Bowden says. They'll give up a big play. We've kept a lot of people in the game.
Yeah, you're right. The Florida State Seminoles will stop you at the line of scrimmage, stop you at the line of scrimmage, and if for some reason, lack of concentration, the big play.
A great day. Temperature about 80. Clear and sunny skies. Georgia goes to the run. And Cleveland Gary, the freshman tailback from Indiantown, Florida, takes the ball ahead for a 10-yard gain. Billy Allen, the strong safety, made the stop for Florida State.
Now, Georgia has not scored a lot of points in the latter stages of this season. One of the reasons may be the problem Vince Dooley feels that the Bulldogs have had all season. They are a tailback offense. Their best runner is a fullback. So if they can get some yardage out of Gary, that's a big plus for him so far.
Third down and short. Loaded backfield for Georgia. Play fake. Williams is hit. Look at the play by Taylor. A ball on the ground. And on third and less than a yard, the Seminoles really come out smoking. A lot of these Florida State players felt that the attitude of the team drop was much like it was before they played Miami early in the season, and they blasted the Hurricanes 38-3.
Don, an interesting comparison between the two coaches. Georgia did a lot of hitting. A lot of hitting in preparation for this game. Florida State did not. As the week went on down here in Orlando, you could see that Florida State was anxious to hit towards the end of the week. I'm not saying one is the right approach and one is the wrong approach, just two different approaches.
Now Georgia ready to punt the ball. Chip Andrews is back. And Darren Holloman is the single safety back deep for Florida State. Seminoles hold on with a big rush. Big kicks away, and it's a good one. And backpedaling, takes the ball at the 7. Excellent coverage by the Dogs, and down goes Darren Holloman at the 8-yard line. A 52-yard punt, a 2-yard return. The Georgia covers well on special teams, and now the State scoring 35 a game, ready to come out.
Happy holidays from Ford and your local Ford dealer.
Grandpa Luke!
Up here, honey.
My friends love your orange juice.
Well, sure, it's naturally sweet.
You see, I let my oranges soak up a full year of sunshine till those oranges of mine fairly burst to overflowing with naturally sweet, delicious Citrus Hill orange juice.
Mmm. You like that naturally sweet taste?
Yeah!
Citrus Hill Orange Juice. There's a year of sunshine in every sip.
Don Crickey with Bob Trumpy back at the Florida Citrus Bowl, the offensive backfield for Florida State, led by Eric Thomas at quarterback, a highly recruited player out of Georgia. Snipes Roosevelt is a very fine runner. He's the tailback, or will be most of the game. Wide receivers, there's a couple of great ones, and Hassan Jones and Jesse Hester. The offensive line is keyed by Jamie Dukes, a 270-pound right guard, second-team All-American. But the Seminoles will start out in the hole after a good punt and excellent coverage by Georgia. They go first and 10 near the Seminoles from their 8-yard line. No score in the first quarter. Looking long. Thomas with a problem. Now he sprints away from it. Turns the corner, and he's across the 15 and out to the 17-yard line. So Eric Thomas, a 6-foot, 195-pound quarterback. Well, the coverage good and took to the run. Defensive line, a big one for the Georgia Bulldogs. Sims and Harris are tough, so is Chumley on the left side. Culpepper in the middle leads the tacklers for the Georgia Bulldogs. He's number one. Sanchez, the number 31, is a consensus All-American at safety. Georgia's strength is its defense. Seminoles with just over a yard now on second down. First back through is the fullback. Running with the ball is Cletus Jones. And he's close to the 20-yard line. Looks like...
Notice this Georgia defense. They stack it up in the middle. Culpepper, the leading tackler, slides laterally very well down as a linebacker in college football. There to make a good tackle. Lots of help from his friends. That's Carlisle Hewitt, also helped on the tackle. And I repeat, Florida State's got to throw the ball in order to loosen up those 7 or 8 guys at the line of scrimmage.
Georgia will jam the front. He's showing he can't throw, and he'll bring everybody up.
Reverse
goes to Jesse Hester. He ripped one of these for 77 yards and a touchdown earlier in the season, and Hester rips off a big gainer. They say he's going to go in perhaps the first round of the NFL draft, a 30-yard gain by the wide receiver.
One of the things you generally find in college football is an offense that you can clearly define. Not the case with Florida State. They will flat do anything. Run the option, run reverses, throw deep, throw short, run screens. This is one of the most multiple offenses you can find in college football. And that's a big problem for Georgia or any team that they play.
And Bobby Bowden said, we're going to go to a lot of extra things in this game because bowl games are special. There's no score. First quarter. Pitch back. Tony Page. Young tailback breaks it. He's going to go. Tony Page. Tony Smith breaks it inside the 15-yard line and gets it down to the 12. Gained by Smith, a junior from Miami.
And this is just a simple little sweep. There's nothing special about it, but the speed of the running backs of Florida State, Tony Smith, Roosevelt, Rosie Snipes. Excellent speed once they get through that line of scrimmage, and every play can be a big play.
Two consecutively now, big plays for Florida State. They're challenging. Smith staying in the game as the tailback. Cletus Jones, the up back. Again, they go to Tony Smith, and he's inside the 10-yard line on a first down carry. Henry Harris and Ken Sims were on the tackle for Georgia. Gators had a big year. Beat both these teams. 9:28 to play. First quarter, no score, but Florida State is challenging on its first possession. They started, you'll recall, deep in their own end at the 8-yard line. Got the big gainer on the end around by Jesse Hester. Then Tony Smith broke the big run. And now it's second down and 6. Second and 8 for a touchdown.
Fumble.
Ball looks like Georgia. The Dogs get it. Andy Loy, a junior defensive end, comes up with the ball. So Florida State coming down with big plays, forced into a turnover, and that's been the history of Georgia. They give up yards, but they stop a lot of people close.
There's a... At the beginning of every football game, Don, there's always a tendency to be a little bit breathless. You can see Smith there looking at the line of scrimmage as opposed to the football. The toss was excellent by Thomas. It should have been caught. We got to put that one on Tony Smith.
So the Seminoles drive well but come up empty, and now Georgia gets the football back. Piloted by Captain Patrick Henry, a 13-year veteran from Parsons, West Virginia. The blimp today is equipped with a prototype mount called Winged Vision, another NBC Sports innovation. The Georgia defense gave up yards, but then came up with the loose ball on the fumble. Tony Smith couldn't handle the pitch back, and now in a scoreless first quarter, Georgia gets its second possession. Up the middle and busting it for real good yardage. A long way to go. Lars Tate is across 50 and down inside the 40, and he's out of bounds at the 37-yard line. A high school All-American a season ago in Indianapolis, a parade All-American. Gainer truck.
Don, you see what happens on that turnover. Now, Tate, a young man, they're trying to get some activity out of the tailback spot. This kid has got great speed, 6'2", 210. He can carry the ball, and they need a lot of that out of that tailback spot today.
Averaged only 3.1 yards a carry in the regular season.
Fumble.
Free ball. Looked like the quarterback, Todd Williams, got the ball for Georgia at the Florida State 41-yard line.
Now, that fumble that Florida State had, remember that these teams have not played in 3 weeks. And you can see that Smith is simply looking at the line of scrimmage instead of the football. And therefore, the turnover, by the way, that run by Tate, his longest of the season.
Roker, 49-yarder, puts the Dogs in good position, but now after that misfire, it's second down and 10. Right again. Down in the Florida State defense rocketing through. Those linebackers are big and they're quick. Henry Taylor and Fred Jones.
They step forward too. Holding Georgia. Those linebackers on the Florida State defense, they do step forward. They will take on a guard, a center. Speaking of the center, the one of the biggest guys I think I've ever seen in my life play center for Georgia. Suffering from a back problem, but is now healthy. Keith Johnson.
Holding. Offense. Second down.
The officials from the ACC, the referee, Donald Seffrit. So they're set back now to the 49-yard line of the Bulldogs, and there it will be second down. Long yardage coming up, second down and 20. They have it marked. Andre Smith is the lone setback. He's been the best runner for the Georgia Bulldogs. The 6-yard carry man. He stays in the block. Swing pass goes out to Huckabee. Jimmy Hockaday gets across midfield again and inside the 45-yard line of the Seminoles, where a freshman corner, Eric Williams, knocked him out of bounds.
To continue on, Keith Johnson, the center for the Georgia Bulldogs, he is 6'5", and I asked him yesterday how much he weighed. He said 310, number 61 right there. Had a bad back throughout the week down here and has never really gotten in shape throughout this season. Making a gutty start today. Vince Dooley hopes he can go the whole way.
No pun intended, a gutty start.
Gutty start, yes.
3-10. Third down, 13. Williams sprints out. Leads the pursuit. Here comes a look at these linebackers coming. Fred Jones, the sophomore from Miami. They've been watching and heard about these Florida State linebackers, and they're special. Big and very fast. Big Fred Jones caught the quarterback.
Excellent design of a defense, too. Georgia is known to roll out some off of that I formation. Fake to the running back. Now watch Jones from outside the picture. Great speed. Quarterback got no place to go.
These two teams haven't played in 19 years, since 1965, even though they're in close proximity. And as you pointed out, Trump, recruit from the same area.
Bragging rights in this game. Whoa! Running into the kicker.
Yep, a penalty marker down. Somebody bumped Chip Andrews as Holloman fields the punt again and goes to the 15-yard line. So the exuberance and over-aggressiveness of the Florida State pursuit is costly, and Georgia's going to get a first down.
Don, you hit it right on the head. Florida State throughout this season has blocked an awful lot of punts, and Joe Wessel, number 5, is the guy that's gotten most of them. Watch what happens here. He knows he's already committed too far. You're supposed to try to, you want to find a spot about 4 yards in front of that punter and not run into him. In an effort to turn the ball game around for his football team, he makes a mental mistake. And I think Joe knows it.
Well, but they give him that license because you see a success story. He's blocked 5 kicks this year, 4 punts and a field goal, and he's returned 3 of the 4 blocked punts for touchdowns. He breaks games open as a punt rusher.
Down to this point, Florida State's been its own worst enemy in bowl games. You don't want to beat yourself. And so far with the fumble and now they're running into the kicker, it gives Georgia continued life offensively.
It does indeed. The Bulldogs with the penalty assessment are down at the 40. Freshman quarterback now in the game for Georgia, James Jackson, a very quick freshman from Camilla, Georgia, has been troubled by a bad ankle. He's the best thrower, although he hasn't put it up much this year, and he's an excellent runner.
Vince Dooley calls him Peanut, and he thinks very highly of this young man. In future years, he's going to be a big man in the offense for Georgia. Still learning, though. He's only played in three games in this 1984 season.
Another freshman, Cassius Osborne, comes out on the right flank. Osborne in motion. Jackson looking at him, and he hits. Ooh. Cassius Osborne turning out. Well-executed play. And the Bulldogs come out throwing now at the freshman in the game, and they move the ball closer. A 14-yard gain.
And that was right on the money. Fred Lane on the reception. That was right on the money. Jackson is not a very big kid, but he has the ball up next to his ear. Has a very quick release. Throws a tight spiral. Obviously got some guts, too, in a ball game like this, coming in there and firing like a veteran.
He's been limping at practice, but running like a racehorse now at game time. First and 10. Hits back. Andre Smith. Peskin flying in. They got some stickers in the Seminole defense. Fred Jones was the first to hit him. The free safety, Brian McCrary, also came in, as did Billy Allen, 31. Vince Dooley, the winningest coach in the 80s of the major college coaches, but not happy the way this season has come down and concluded in the regular season with three consecutive losses.
He's got to be happy to this point, though, Don.
He's getting offense that he hasn't had. The road. Cleveland Gary has his hat fly off as he has stuck the freshman runner, and Henry Taylor was the guy that got him along with Isaac Williams.
One of the things that allows those linebackers to be so aggressive, great confidence in the defensive line. Watch Taylor, always stepping up, never steps back. Someone over there gets a hand on number 83 for Florida State, gets a hand in his face. Stanley Scott.
Andre Smith still in the game. He's the up back. Ninth play of this drive now for Georgia. No score in the first quarter. Going to screen, but it's shut off. Jackson with a problem, and he runs out of time at the 30. The nose tackle, Todd Stroud, finally got him down. Good defense as Florida State cordoned off the field, gave him no place to run.
You're right. Let's give an assist to Billy Taylor. Billy Allen. He was over there to cover that screen, and Jackson had nobody to throw to, and then he went to scrambling.
That's Stroud from St. Pete. Now Kevin Butler. They call him Kevin It's Good Butler. Two-time All-American place kicker. A 46-yard attempt, which as far as distance for him is an extra point. This is one of the great kickers in college football history. He hits it. But this time, Kevin Butler, who's been down with the flu all week, doesn't get it. So even the best kicker in the country can have a bad shot. Joe Wessel put some heat on again, Trump.
They call Kevin Butler the most popular Butler since Rhett in Georgia. Wessel almost gets it. Hooked slightly left. Butler will have more chances.
Joe Wessel got the job done because he harassed the kicker. Florida State has the football. We come back to the Florida Citrus Bowl.
Raise your hand.
You got it.
Raise your hand.
You know it. You feel confident, secure.
If you want to feel confident, raise your hand. If you want to feel secure, raise your hand. If you want protection that helps you feel dry all day, raise your hand and reach for sure.
Confident, confident, dry and secure. Raise your hand. Raise your hand if you're sure. Raise your hand. Raise your hand if you're sure.
You know what I don't like about dandruff? Dandruff shampoos. I'm afraid they won't leave my hair the way I like it. This shampoo cares for my hair. It's the only one with a self-balancing formula. Puts dandruff protection where I need it, on my scalp, not on my hair, and it conditions where I need it.
Ball again, but there's no score on the board. Both teams have moved it well. Eric Thomas, home run ball. Flying downfield, trying to get under it is Carlton Scott.
Catch.
And it's Intercepted by Georgia. Kevin Harris, the right corner, who was a starting wide receiver for 2 years for Georgia, changed roles, and now he's trying to stop those wide receivers, and he did.
You look at the speed he has for a kid his size. He's 6 foot, 195 pounds, but watch him keep up with these spinners from Florida State. That's a 47-yard pass, excellent concentration on the football. Big turnover again for Georgia. To this point, it's going all their way.
We'll be back. Right half turned over the ball 9 times in a 1-point loss to Auburn in the second half. Has 2 turnovers in the first quarter here to stop drives. And now Georgia has it back. No score.
Look at this.
Jackson, look at this man go. James Jackson, the freshman quarterback who came in when the starter Todd Williams hyperextended a knee and might not play for the rest of the day. And a 20-yard gain, although that's Vince Dooley said they were planning to go to Jackson.
If you wonder if that was planned or unplanned, obviously planned. He had a lineman right in front of him.
Right now, we pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC Television Network.
WTBA 9.
Back to live action, first and 10. And Kalars take the freshman tailback, goes Georgia, and he's across the 45. Don Cricky with Bob Trumpy, 3:38 to play in the first quarter. As we have Kevin Harris, the man who just intercepted on a 47-yard throw downfield being attended to.
Don, this is the best thing that could happen to Georgia, and that is keep the Florida State offense off the field. Vince Dooley got to be very happy. Bobby Bowden very unhappy that his offense has not had many chances so far in this first quarter.
But Dooley said we've got to keep the ball, and now they go to Tron Jackson. He doesn't get much as Florida State does a good job on an option run, jamming up the middle, forcing him outside. Gerald Nichols, the right tackle, was the tackler on Tron Jackson.
This Florida State defense is a good defense, but it's not a defense you can keep on the field for an extended period of time. They will break down. So you can look for a big play coming up here quick.
And the Florida Citrus Bowl, a fast-rising enterprise with Orlando and Orange counties behind it, and the Florida Citrus Growers. Almost another free football, but picked up and hopped right to Jackson. But he's not going to go anywhere, as the pursuit by the Florida State defenders has been excellent. Isaac Williams ran him down along with Jesse Solomon.
Well, two turnovers by Florida State, and then running into the kicker. And now Georgia has a miscue. Florida State, I think, has got to be a little more conservative. They came into this ball game averaging 51 rushes a game, done for the 1984 season. And I still think Bobby Bowden is attempting to loosen up that defense by throwing it deep.
Right now, we got a 10-man rush coming at Andrews. Chip Andrews, the Georgia punter. Wessel again, they pick him up nicely, though, but it's not that good a punt, although it's kicked away from Darren Holloman. Finally, the ball is down by a Georgia pursuer. Wilbur Strozier puts a hand on it, so it started to hop upfield. So the Seminoles come back out on offense. They've had big plays, but big mistakes. They've turned it over twice. No score.
If you've got what it takes and really care, there's a special kind of life you'll want to share.
State goes against the Trojans of USC. Finally, New Year's Day night, Oklahoma Sooners, number 2 in the country against number 3 Washington. The Orange Bowl coming up. Don't miss all the excitement on New Year's Day. America loves its sport, NBC style, as Roosevelt Snipes. In the game, he didn't start because he missed a practice in the week. Comes in now and runs the ball where Kevin Harris knocks him down. First down carry is good for 3.
There's the Florida State defense gathered on the sideline trying to reiterate assignments. There's been a couple of busted assignments. Plays run out the backside of the defense that shouldn't generally happen.
It's been wide open. 1:16 to play. First quarter, still no score, but a lot of offensive yards. Florida State moving the ball downfield. Going to the whole array of offensive weapons, including a wide receiver around play that gained 50. Then they got down close and there was a fumbled ball. Now the Seminoles go 2nd and 7 from their 26-yard line. Good fake by Eric Thomas, but good penetration by the Georgia defense.
Don Thomas was buried. You're right, the penetration did it to him.
That front line of Georgia, Trump, right off the ball very quickly, and they're hitting hard at the offensive
front. When you run the option, that's what can happen to you. Now watch what happens to Thomas. He fakes to the dive man. There are already people in the backfield. 56 is right there in his face to make sure Billy Mitchell, to make sure things don't go well. They do count it as a completion, though. Third and about four.
Three wide receivers set on a third and fourth play for Florida State. Thomas swings it out. Cedric Jones takes the ball ahead, and he's got a first down for Florida State as he's out to the 38-yard line. The number one tackler for the Dogs, Knox Culpepper, knocked him down, but well downfield. A big gain, 11 yards.
This is still trying to loosen up that defensive front. They got seven guys up there within 3 yards of the line of scrimmage on. This is a great catch. And once he gets the ball, he turns inside. Jamie Dukes, number 64, is blocked. Playing in his hometown here. First down, Florida State.
Now, Roosevelt snipes as aligned as the tailback deep in the eye. First and 10. Fake to snipes. Eric Thomas fires and throws a strike on the run. Gets it to his tight end, Cat Carter, a big freshman from Sarasota, Florida. And it's very close to another first down. Looks like he's got one. So a well-thrown ball by Eric Thomas, and the Seminoles move the ball again. They'll be back with first and 10 after this.
Oh, what Sylvania light bulbs go through.
In Disney World outside Orlando.
Coaches, both coaches were concerned that their kids had so much to do down here that they may have lost their legs for the game. Told them yesterday, rest, sleep, get off your feet.
Well, they came out ready when the bell rang, and right now, with no score up, despite a lot of offense, the Seminoles go to the run right up the middle on a good fake by the quarterback, Eric Thomas, after he handed the ball off. Looked like he kept the ball.
From behind the defense, Jamie Dukes, number 64, and Ionata, 77. They like to stand right next to each other. Look at Cletus Jones drag people there. Excellent, tough running yards up the middle. First down, FSU.
Eric Thomas, you'll see him fake to the fullback, then spin out and run an option with that trailer. Pitchback now. Snipes. Spins off the tackle by Bill Mitchell and gets ahead. On a first down carry, he's inside the 35-yard line of Georgia. Goes about it right at the 35. Snipes came into the game. And they say he's very close to Greg Allen, the All-American tailback, who's injured right now. Arthroscopic knee surgery that kept him out the last few games, but Snipes isn't far behind, although he's not as big. Allen's 2'8". Roosevelt Snipes 5'9", 180. Second down and 5 coming up for Florida State. The scoreless game, second quarter. Low ball.
No.
Carlton Scott, the freshman, had his hands on it, ruled incomplete.
Bounced off the ground. Now, what they're trying to do there is taking advantage of the Georgia cushion by their cornerbacks.
Has been concerned about the consistent ball. Now Florida State has to punt. Lewis Berry's in. A nephew of a former All-Pro punter wears the same number for Houston, John James.
Ron, that was also a loss of down. Because the Georgia got the penalty. And it was third down. No, I think they're going to count the play. Ah, that makes a little more sense.
Move the ball back to the 40. But the Seminoles still a long way, and so it's fourth down and 10, and they'll punt it.
Ball responded at the 40-yard line.
Two good punters in the game. The punter for the Georgia Bulldogs, Chip Andrews, averages over 45 a punt, as you see Barry over 42, and he hangs a high one. It'll bounce inside the 5. Kept out. Downed at the 1. Special teams play nonpareil. Perfectly done by Florida State. So Georgia gets the ball back, but they'll be 98 yards from where they want to be. We'll be back after this.
Right linebacker, number 80, tips it back. And then 38, Paul McGowan makes the play, a freshman inside linebacker, down at the 1-yard line.
So first and 10 from there. Second back through, spinning off is Cleveland Gary. He works himself out to the 5. Fumble. Florida State thinks they had the ball. We'll see what the officials rule. Might have been down.
The ground can't cause a fumble. Second down, Georgia.
So Georgia gets a break, keeps the ball, and gets out of jail at least a little bit.
From behind the offense, there's very little of your offense you can run down here, Don. And if you're a coach, whoa, that ball looked like it got loose before he was on the ground. You really don't want fancy moves out of your running backs down there. Be conservative. Hang on to the football.
Second down, 5. Long ball, and it overthrown everybody. We see that young Mr. Jackson can air it out despite his small stature.
55 yards in the air. That was definitely overthrown.
This has been Georgia's best quarter. You see, they've scored 41% of their points, but their offense went southbound in the last few games, scored only 43 points in the final four games, 43 total. Florida State puts up the big numbers on offense, 35 points a game. Coach Dooley's been at it a long time, is concerned about this game. He doesn't want to close with 4 losses. He said, we look on this as the start of our new season, but it's a good way to conclude the old one. Again, getting a lot of work is Cleveland Gary, a 6'2", 210-pound freshman. Carries the ball out to the 10, but he'll be a couple of yards short of where he had to go. And so, Georgia will punt it. Florida State front could get good field position
this
here.
This is Florida State's quarter, too. In the second quarter, they've scored 110 points throughout the season. They seem to take a quarter to get going, find out what the defense is going to do, and then really turn it loose.
One of the best punters in the country. You see that per punt average, over 45 yards. Andrews will hit it, though, from his end zone. Darren Holloman is back deep for Florida State. Big rush. He just got it away, and again, a marker's down. Georgia downs the ball at the 47-yard line.
I would tend to think that Florida State was offsides. A little too anxious here. Offsides.
You got it. Florida State. Down. Fourth and 2. They'll get 5, and the Georgia offense comes back out.
That's twice now that Florida State has allowed Georgia new life. It looks like Joe Wessel jumped off sides. He's an important part of this team, but he's got to help a little more and hurt a little less.
Scott Williams, a tight end who sat in the blocking back position on punts, has been sticking Wessel. They've seen what he can do.
Well, this is Wessel's senior year. He's already graduated. Graduated a week ago in the business, going to work for a large conglomerate in this country, wants to go out and blaze the glory, but you want him to play within himself in a game like this.
Georgia having trouble getting in the end zone, now moving the ball out. There's Jackson rolling out. Fires a strike, and look at this. It's going to go for a big, big gainer as Herman Archie takes the ball and gets out across the 45-yard line. Herman Archie is the man who gets the job done, a junior, a deep ball threat. 30-yard gain.
Averages over 19 yards a catch. Once again, very impressed with Jackson. Good fake. Has the presence to wait for Archie to open up. Takes a hit, still gets the ball out there, even though it's in the over end. And Wessel, the man in coverage. And a picking on Joe Wessel.
Back to live action. First back through is the fullback for Georgia, Andre Smith. He's out to the 48-yard line where Fred Jones knocked him down. There's UGA. UGA the 4th. Actually a pretty nice little dog.
Is that right? I'll take your word for it.
That Florida State horse didn't run around.
Yeah. That. Horses don't like dogs.
Got a big fire hydrant out they put over by the Georgia bench for UGA. Fires Tate, trying to cut upfield, lost his footing. Georgia giving the ball a lot, Bob, to the freshman tailback.
Don, that hole was there, too. Excellent job. Short sweep run by Georgia. Tell you what, Florida State has just self-destructed here, been their own worst enemy. They've extended drives twice with foolish penalties and those two turnovers. And Georgia's in this ball game, and I repeat, Florida State's defense being on the field this much to this point in the game is not what Florida State wants.
Nothing score. 10:50 to play, first half. Jackson throws, and the only guy with a play on the ball was the free safety, Brian McCrary. Cassius Osborne, another freshman, was the intended receiver. So Georgia gets out of jail for a while. They started at their 1 year, remember. Gets down the field, but now they have to punt the ball.
Well, let's see what Florida State can do this time to extend life.
Florida State with a lot of confidence in Darren Holloman, a freshman. 5'7", 165, low to the ground. You're not sure when he's down. Keeps on running low. He's a great little return man. Here he comes.
Ooh, he lost the football.
I think Florida State got it back.
They did. 42-yard punt, a 10-yard return by Holloman. Lost the handle. But right there to get it. Brian Williams, number 47.
Tony Mangren and Bill O'Leary on the hit. This is a driving punt. Holloman tries to come right back up the middle, and it gets spun around there, ball loose, but Florida State recovers.
Football's on the field. There's been a lot of those. Coach Bowden, talking to him earlier, they're talking about some of the land around Orlando that was in the 1960s sold for $200 an acre up by Disney World. It's now worth...
Holden, offense, second down.
It's now worth $300,000 an acre. $200 an acre to $300,000. Bobby said, yeah, that sounds like the patch of land the Bowden sold a few years back.
He's a folk hero, a storyteller, a darn good football coach, and one with an awful lot of courage. He'll run anything, anywhere. Wouldn't be surprised right now is a good time for a reverse to the wide side of the field. Something like that.
Well, they did it before, and it worked well. Eric Thomas with five throws, three completions, 25 yards. He's been intercepted once on that long ball. Looking to throw. Here's the problem. Gets it away. Diving play on the ball by Hassan Jones. Chumley was on him. A big day of football on NBC Sports after the Florida Citrus Bowl. It's up to the Kingdom in Seattle. The AFC wild card game. The Raiders and the Seahawks hook up in the rubber game. They've met twice this year and split.
Comment on Florida State. They're not getting very good pass protection up front. Chumley was there as Thomas set up to throw. The receiver was open. If Thomas had been able to set up, I think it would have been a completion. Look at all those people at the line of scrimmage. Two, four, five, six, seven people you can see.
Clint. Whoa. Nice read by Eric Thomas. Gets it away. Tony Smith runs upfield on third down and 17. He's across the 25-yard line. Well short of a first down, though. And the Seminoles will have to punt the ball again. Bill Mitchell and Henry Harris put the heat on.
We are seeing some linebacker play here, aren't we?
Seeing some gambling, too. People shooting the gaps.
Culpepper and Mitchell for Georgia.
Red Lane will go back as a deep safety now for Georgia. Tony Flack up front with him. And Lewis Berry, number six, ready to hit the ball for the Seminoles. It's off a fairly good punt. Angles out of bounds. They pick a trick football here. All the punts seem to bounce back the wrong way.
There's no wind. Beautiful day in Orlando.
32-yarder. So, we still continue with no score on the board and 8:38 to play in the first half.
Okay. The punt team by Florida State, the punt return team by Florida State's made a couple of mistakes. I'm rather surprised. It's been one of the biggest parts of their team this year.
A lot of emotion. Young players, they've been waiting for this game. Jackson, a freshman, throws too much at it. He was going for Anthony Clincy, number 89. They really think James Jackson, number 14 there, can turn into a great player. Has all the goods. He's speed, arm, smart.
Well, obviously, too, with Todd Williams out with a hyperextended knee, Jackson is going to get his best look of the season. There's no question about that.
Georgia has moved the ball better than they did late in the regular season. Tight end and an end around. Scott Williams, boy, he is banged hard. He got to the line of scrimmage and hit a wall of garnet and gold.
This has got to be a big plus so far for Georgia. They are keeping the Florida State offense off the field. There's Georgia trying to figure out exactly what to do defensively the next time they get out there.
There's been some hitting today, and we're going to listen to the sound of college football right now.
All right.
Well, tell you, one guy heard some sound, and that was the quarterback, James Jackson, because Henry Taylor, the linebacker, came on a blitz and popped him just as he got rid of the ball.
Scott Williams on the catch. Once again, Jackson shows me an awful lot of maturity here. He waits. Throws that ball low into the outside. The tight end Williams gets that one foot in bounds, which makes it a legal catch in college football, but it's not enough for a first down. They have a fake punt. Have they ever run a fake punt?
Georgia not too often. Chip Andrews ready to hit it again. Joe Wessel has been a little over anxious, is not in now to rush the punter. Playing for position.
They're going to get it. No.
That way they're not. Into the end zone it goes for a touchback. Despite the best efforts of Wilbur Strozier, number 79. So the Dogs so far are keeping the high-scoring Seminoles scoreless, but the Dogs don't have any points themselves. They're going to open this thing up with a long pass pretty soon. We'll be back right after this. Talking to Vince Dooley about he now has two players who are the sons of former players of his. Asked him if he starts to feel old with the sons coming back to places. No, the ball players are getting younger.
Very much, yeah.
He expects to have a couple coming back a year now. 21 years as the coach of Georgia.
Has a Labrador retriever at home named Herschel. I don't know for a Southern gentleman if there's any higher compliment than to name your dog after someone you like.
And they like Herschel.
Yes, they did.
Herschel Walker. The man who led Georgia to its only national championship.
We got a quick out down here.
Eric Thomas can't hit it, though, and he's got it unloaded. Oh, free ball. Big play by Donald Chumley, a 265-pound defensive tackle from Savannah. He got Eric Thomas number high with his helmet.
They're reading the defense, and they were trying to throw a quick out, and then you see the Rover, number 19, drop out right in front of the intended receiver, John Little. And Thomas tried to throw it deep, and his arm was hit by Chumley. Incomplete.
Great second look. Our producer for NBC Sports is Peter Rolfe. Our director, Richard Klein. As the punt downfield again by Lewis Berry is fielded on the run. Red Lane living dangerously as he gets the ball across the 45. No return. Eric Thomas waiting to get that offense cooking. It hasn't happened so far since that early drive that came up empty. Play in the first half and no score. Bobby Bowden, the coach of Florida State, said he was concerned about having two quarterbacks from South Georgia starting the game, so we might have some delay of game penalties. They can run fast, but they talk slow.
Yes.
Raya, 12. Jackson drops on first down. Let's it go long. The ball is taken by Fred Lane inside the 10, and he's down to the 4. Freshman sophomore pass catch combination. James Jackson and Fred Lane, a 50-yard gain for Georgia.
The coverage by Eric Williams of Florida State, also a freshman. Jackson aired this one out, full trajectory. Lane just caught that punt. He's now got two catches for 64 yards, and this is what you call opening up the offense, kids.
Up the middle, running hard for some yards, but not many, as Lars Tate. This is where Henry Taylor becomes an even greater force, stuffing the run on the in-close defense. Vince Dooley had it like that. He said, we need some big plays, haven't got any lately. And the freshman came in when the starter, Todd Williams, was shaken up. And now Jackson with a 50-yard throw to Fred Lane has the Bulldogs down close in a scoreless game. It's second down and goal. Bulldogs with only two touchdowns in the last 15 quarters, so they haven't seen the inside of the end zone too often.
Illegal procedure. Herman Archie turned up too early. Play will come back.
Pass was intended for Bill O'Leary, number 33.
That's it.
This team all season has had a lot of trouble scoring, as you said. Their field goal kicker, Butler's got 94 points. And the next closest scorer has got 24 points.
That hurts. Down close, second and goal from the 4.
Offense. Third down.
Yep, they think they can hold him out.
You'll see Archie turn up. Yes, that's... You can't make motion towards the line of scrimmage. That's illegal.
Coach at Arizona State was quoted as having told his offensive line, man, it's better that you died at birth than jump offside of the goal line.
Jackson now 4 of 8, 102 yards. I think this is a pass right here, Don.
Looks like it. Two on the left flank. Now they're going to the run, and Lars Taylor's into the end zone. Touchdown, Georgia. The Dogs deliver on offense.
Tate, his fifth carry on the day. Now got 56 yards in that touchdown. Nice little delay by Georgia. You can see the counter step by Lars Tate. Watch him step to the left. And then right back to the right. 79 and 64 pull right in front of him. Let's give him credit when we can. Strozier and Pete Anderson do an excellent job of cleaning out the outside linebackers. Tate in for the touchdown.
Butler hasn't missed an extra point in recent memory. And he nails that one. Devin Butler. The two-time All-American place kicker puts up a seventh point, and Georgia, the underdog, with the big play from the freshman to the sophomore for 50 yards, takes it in. Lars Tate, another freshman on the payoff end. It's 7-0 Bulldogs.
Say goodbye to America's favorite can of motor oil. That Quaker State quality America has trusted for over 70 years now comes exclusively in this unique, easy-to-pour plastic bottle.
So long, spouts.
See you, dirty hands.
Goodbye, oily rags.
No more leaky cans.
Get Quaker State's pen-grade protection and no mess. Easy to open, pour, and reseal. Today, you need an oil this good in a package this good.
We're back at Orlando Stadium, a boom town in the Florida Sun Belt, where the Georgia Bulldogs, an underdog, have just mounted an impressive drive to put up the first points of the game. Lars Tate on the payoff end after a 50-yard pass play set it up with a first and goal. They want to think again, Trump, about not taking that penalty.
Yeah, you're right. An excellent point to make.
Could have been second and goal from the nine, but they elected to make it third and goal from the four, and Tate took it in.
Four plays, 55 yards, a minute and 12 seconds, and a four-yard run by Tate.
Deep men back for Florida State are Carlton Scott and Roosevelt Snipes. Butler hits it, a high spinner. Short for him, it went to the goal line.
Oh, that was close.
Freshman Carlton Scott rips it up the middle, gets across the 20 to the 22 with 5:21 to play in the first half. Randy Jackson came down to make the play, and here comes Eric Thomas, who's had his problems moving the ball.
You can see the offensive output.
That first one was the killer.
Yeah, the Florida State Seminoles this season have been outstanding offensively. They got nothing so far. That 81-yard drive and a fumble. You're right, Don. That takes a lot of wind out of your sails.
They were down close, looking like they go in on their first possession, then a fumbled pitch. Georgia got it back, and Georgia leads the game now 7-0. Snipes from the tailback. He's playing way off the line of scrimmage. You get time to read the holes, but there weren't any.
I'll tell you what, this Georgia defense, too, on alignment, they're about a yard off the football, Don, and they catch and read. You'll see their defensive linemen just fire a form at the offensive lineman of the Florida State Seminoles and then stand there and wait for the running back to get to them. They're good, strong people up front. Now watch how far off the ball they are as we look right down the yard marker there. And they make liars out of me. Now the guy's right up on the football.
They generally, are jamming this day. Generally, our back, there's no question. Yeah. Here's a throw, and the ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage. A man was open, the tight end Pat Carter coming across. Thomas had him all the way, but Wycliffe Lovelace on our all-name team tipped the ball.
You can see him dropping out, too. He's a defensive lineman. He makes contact. Now watch him drop
94.
Out. And watch him drop out. Gets his hands up, which is what defensive... he didn't get his hands up. Hit him right in the helmet.
Why not? Wycliffe Lovelace blocks it with his helmet. So now Eric Thomas with 9 throws for 34 yards and 4 completions and the 1 interception. They're ready to pitch now. Good throw. Jesse Hester gets it, but they hold him short of the first down, it would appear. Let's see where they spot the ball. Jet Hester off the right flank coming across.
Hester, one of the great pass receivers in college football, averaged close to 20 yards a catch. That was his first catch in a ball game.
Bowden says that Jesse Hester is potentially greater than even Fred Biletnikoff of Raider fame because he's much faster. Hester caught 42 passes in the regular season for a 20-yard per catch average. 9 times he went in the end zone with caught balls.
You're faster than Biletnikoff, and Freddie knows that, but could still play.
And for a long time. Dropping. Thomas throws, and a good defensive play. Calvin Ruff covering, and Pat Carter can't get to the ball as it's slapped down. Calvin Ruff can also sack the quarterback from the left-end position, which is really like a stand-up outside linebacker.
Correct.
5 sacks he has this year. Big day on NBC Sports, the American Conference wild card game from Seattle. The Raiders and the Seahawks, 2 avowed enemies. They'll be hooking up immediately following the Florida Citrus Bowl. We'll be getting a preview also at halftime as we go to NFL 84 in New York. Swing pass. No good. Sanchez was the man who got a hand on it. It was interesting, but it was almost a flaming disaster for the Seminoles.
Hassan Jones to Jesse Hester. Well covered by Jeff Sanchez. Let's see this play again. You see Hester go in like he's going to block. Jones go back because that must be a lateral from the quarterback. Flack, number 8, was right in Jones's face. Sanchez on the other end for coverage. Watch Sanchez. He's the center fielder back there. He's not fooled.
First team All-American, Jeff Sanchez from Yorba Linda, California, with an All-American play. So, a trick play, nothing. Sanchez almost had the ball for the Bulldogs. 3rd and 10 coming up for Florida State when we come back. Now we go to live action. Eric Thomas on the rollout. Firing tip ball. Once again, Florida State has to punt it. Tony Flack was on the play.
6'3", Tony Flack, a cornerback. Doing an excellent job there of getting the ball up in the air. So far, the Florida State receivers have been very well covered.
Lewis Berry back in to punt again. Ed Marinero could play football.
Yes, he could.
The NCAA at Cornell as a senior.
New York Jets running back.
Long punt by Lewis Berry. He went down, but there's no flag. Georgia trying to return. A lot of Garnett and Gold there. Been a streak fight on special teams. They've come really striking. Jimmy Harrell was the first man down. 47-yard punt and a 3-yard return and a marker down with 3:16 to play in the first half.
That's going to be against Georgia. After the ball is punted, it'll be assessed clipping. Yes, it'll go back. Penalty. Major penalty. I don't think the Florida State Seminoles have been shut out in a half they've played this year. There's 3:16 left. They're about to have that done to them.
Well, Galen Hall, the coach of Florida, who's at the game, the team defeated both these teams in the regular season, said to stop Florida State, you have to stop the big play. And he said to stop Georgia, you can't let them have the big play.
They've done that.
Big plays have been the difference. It was a 50-yarder.
Receiving team doing a run back. First down.
Don, we've seen Bobby Bowden in bowl games before at the Orange Bowl. Now, this year, he doesn't have the headset on. Next year, apparently, he's going to put it back on, call his own plays. And this year, he's been an administrator on the sideline.
Well, 1 year at the Orange Bowl, one of the greatest Orange Bowls, Oklahoma edged Florida State 18-17. It's Bowden Mike. He was calling the plays with cars as a key.
Yes.
Broncos at number 25.
Sending a couple of Edsels at the end, he said.
Going to the right.
Ron Jackson running the ball there in first down.
Number 43, Brian.
Back to Orlando Stadium as we look on. From high above in the Goodyear blimp.
Ball up to the 19-yard line.
Second down and two. Getting his way is Lars Tate, who has scored the game's only touchdown. The freshman runner from Indianapolis having his best game as a Bulldog. Cleveland Gary also in the game. Jesse Solomon made the stop.
Now, Don, if you could characterize the first half to this point, it has basically been that Georgia has established control of the line of scrimmage against Florida State. Florida State offensively has not done that at all. Georgia keeps banging it in there. Florida State's going to the trick plays, the back page of the playbook.
Going to that back page early. James Jackson, remember that 50-yarder. Here comes another one downfield. Cassius Osborne going for the ball, and it's tipped away.
That's good coverage.
Martin Mayhew and Brian McCrary reporting very good coverage.
When the ball is up in the air that long, that's when the defensive back is in the most jeopardy, because you've got to get to the ball, not make contact with the receiver, and still knock the ball away. Now watch the way these two guys, they keep track of the receiver, try to avoid contact as best they can. Great job. Just tipped away by Martin Mayhew, or another big play for the Bulldogs.
Georgia throwing the ball a lot today, Trump. They have 119 passing yards, normally a running team. Florida with only, as you see, 42 passing yards. Georgia leads 7-0. Ron Jackson. Hey, those runners, when they look at that Garnett and Gold defense, you know you're going to pay a price running into it. They're
right.
Team hitters.
Tron, nicknamed Electron by his teammates. Georgia's done an excellent job at the line of scrimmage, Don. That's the big key in this first half. They've established control with running the football. Florida State has not.
Coach Dooley feeling much better about things as the game wears on. His team leading 7-0. Third and four. Draw didn't get there. Andre Smith, the sophomore fullback, running straight ahead with 2:16 in the clock running in the second quarter. Georgia will again punt the ball back to Florida State. A tremendous halftime show from Disney World here at the Florida Citrus Bowl. Also a preview of the AFC wild card game. We'll switch to New York for that. The Raiders and the Seahawks are coming up next on NBC Sports today from the King Dome in Seattle.
Joe Wessel back in the punt return team for Florida State.
Darren Holloman's back deep. Here comes Holloman.
He's down.
Grass field, lost his footing, cutting back. An excellent playing field. 43-yard punt, just a 2-yard return. 1:13 to go now in the first half, Trump, and Florida's going to have to start firing.
You're right. This may be the two-minute offense that Florida State likes to use, and it may help them get out of the lethargy that they've shown in the first half. Georgia, I would imagine, will play a much different defense now because there is just 1:13 left. It may shake Florida State awake.
Thomas, the quarterback.
Set the eye with Eric Thomas at quarterback, junior from Lake Park, Georgia. Pick up the blitz. Here comes the rush. Intercepted. Kevin Harris has it for Georgia. And Harris is finally knocked out of bounds by the quarterback who threw the intercept. Eric Thomas gets him inside the 15. Might have stepped out of bounds at about the 18. See where they spot it. But Georgia's defense comes up with another big play.
Don,
two interceptions today.
Excuse me. Let's give a big assist to John Little, the rover back. Now, what he did was he went with Snipes. Now, watch this. This is set up as a screen all the way. When Thomas rolls out here, you'll see the man in coverage right underneath Roosevelt Snipes. There's nobody. Oh, excuse me. I got 19. It's not 19. It's 39. Andy Lloyd. And Harris is there to make the interception. That's three big turnovers for Florida State in the first half. Now watch once again. You see 39. As soon as Snipes goes out, you can see him at the top of the screen. He covers it. Now Thomas has got no receiver, but he still throws it. Harris there to make the interception.
That was quacking when it came down.
Yes, it was. It shouldn't have been thrown.
And duck pass.
And Don, still, it appears to me that Florida State going with the trick plays.
trying to do something fancy as opposed to something sound and fundamental.
Kevin Harris, as we pointed out earlier, was a two-time starter. Past 2 years at wide receiver. Used to try to beat the cornerbacks. Now he is one. And he's got two interceptions today, so he's still catching the ball.
He's got great hands. He's made two very difficult interceptions.
Georgia has a lot of time, too, from this field position to take it in. 1:22 to play in the first half. A lot of emotion, a lot of hitting, a lot of mistakes often forced in these highly emotional bowl game. 1:22 left to play first half. Georgia with the ball at the 13-yard line. Florida State.
I notice Bobby Bowden is walking the sideline faster and faster as problems arise. He'll be in a gallop here if this continues in the second half. He looked like Renegade.
Renegade's the horse that comes out when they score, but he hasn't been seen today. Jackson throws and overthrows. James Jackson, the freshman quarterback, trying to get the ball downfield to Andre Smith.
I think you're right. There was a receiver in the end zone, Hockaday, but I do believe he was throwing the ball to Andre Pulpwood Smith. He was wide open there with nobody in coverage.
Jackson, 4 of 10 for 102 yards, but 50 of them came on that throw to Fred Lane that set up the first and goal at the 4, and the subsequent touchdown only score of the game.
He can run, too, Don.
Yes, he can. James Jackson, the QB, 2nd and 10. Likes to roll out when he throws. Goes to the run, and right up the middle is Lyles Tate, the freshman who scored the game's only touchdown. He's down to the 1 yard line, and he's got a first down.
That 6'5", 310-pound offensive center, Keith Johnson, Stevens, Anderson, Strozier, Weaver doing an outstanding job up front. Look, there's nobody to even lay a glove on Lars Tate. They are blowing people out up front. Georgia is against Florida State, and once again, the theme of this first quarter is just controlling the line of scrimmage, something that Florida State has not done at all. 57 had the best shot. John Eford didn't come close.
Lars Tate averaging 11 yards a carry. His best day as a Bulldog runner, 6 carries, 67 yards, 1 touchdown, and he got it down close enough where it's first and goal for the Bulldogs again. Not what Florida State was expecting. They thought they'd get out in front early. Dooley said it was critical that we get points up early.
And I also want to key into our watching audience. Don't turn the TV off, because this big play Florida State offense can score so many points in such a short time that there is no lead that's a good enough lead to keep Florida State down.
Score them against good teams, too. 41 against Auburn, but it was one short.
Look at these coaches. Those guys are ready to play, too. Looks like a couple of them got their ankles taped before they kicked it off here today.
Our formation on offense. Georgia over the top. Lars Tate in the end zone for a second time. The Dogs are doing it right now.
Well, we set up this football game as the defense of the Dogs is the part of the Georgia Bulldogs that bites. The offense has done the damage today. That's very reminiscent of a guy named Walker who used to do that for Georgia a lot. 7 carries, 69 yards now, 2 touchdowns for Lars Tate. And look at the bow they get in that defensive line of scrimmage. They've done a great job controlling that line of scrimmage.
Your man Johnson, the big center, blew people back, gave him room to go over the top. Butler drills the extra point. So again, the Bulldogs capitalize on a turnover and put up the second touchdown of the game. Georgia, the decided underdog, leading Florida State 14-0 with 1:08 to play in the first half.
This is a football team, too, that after being off for 3 weeks, they have come out in this first half and been very emotional. Doesn't appear that they're worn out at all. What's that?
Lake Lorna Dune.
Really? It's the shape of a cookie.
Peter Rolfe says, I'm going to go with it.
Okay.
A lot of lakes in this part of the country. Well, it's inland, of course, Orlando, as everyone in this area knows, but people in other parts might not be familiar with the geography. It's a boom town, Orlando, Florida.
I'll tell you what, you never know what site you're going to see here. Last night,
you're going to see hotels with, yes, 28 million visitors.
And I'm also going to dinner last night with my family about 8 o'clock. Look over to the right. And Cape Kennedy's over there, and I see a rocket going up. We stopped right in the middle of the street. There were some Floridians rather upset with this, but it was a sight to behold.
The rocket went up last
yeah,
night.
Yeah, there was, I don't know if it was one of the...
Did you see this late
space rocket? What?
Did you see this late at night?
Yes, there was no UFO reported this morning, so we all watched right in the middle of the street.
Carlton Scott is back deep for Florida State. Seminoles with a problem. Butler kicks off. Spinner goes downfield. Running back with the ball for Florida State. Dwayne Denson, and he gets it across the 25. As we pause briefly for station identification, this is the NBC television network.
Made by number 42, John Bradley, and number 47, Randy Jackson.
Lars Tate in the end zone twice today for Georgia, getting reshot.
John Brantley, linebacker for Georgia on the tackle there. 104 left. Florida State's got to do something here to just get their minds right.
I'll tell you one thing Eric Thomas is going to see is a big rush. Georgia's really been putting the pressure on. They go to the run. Tony Smith runs the ball, broke a big one early on first down. But Florida State needs a lot more than that.
Jake Richardson on the tackle.
8 years since the Seminoles have been shut out in a half. 35 points a game they're averaging. They lost that game to Miami 47-0.
Ooh.
A long time ago, early in the career of Coach Bowden, in his 9 years at Florida State, the Seminoles have won 71% of their games.
Look at that defensive line out, Don. Watch him catch. See there? Now once the running back goes through, then they get to the quarterback.
Jake Richardson. 99.
And you can see that defensive front. There's a lot of people up there. Their first idea is simply to catch those offensive linemen. And then once the running back's clear, then they go after the quarterback. Now that takes a lot of time. That means that Eric is not getting very good pass protection at all.
Vince Dooley was saying yesterday that the problem has been with our defense playing good and playing good. They don't get any encouragement from the offense, but today they have.
You're right.
The offense has turned mistakes into touchdowns.
This has got to be a day at the beach for the Georgia defense, because the offense today is here to play.
So at halftime, a surprise leader at the Florida Citrus Bowl, the Bulldogs of Georgia, leading the Florida State Seminoles 14
passing yards. Those are the yards that surprise most people who are dog fans. And it's got to please Vince Dooley. He's in control of a football game against a very good opponent who has been big play crazy throughout this season, and he shut down those big plays. On the other side, Bobby Bowden's got to wonder, wait a minute, you know, the personality of this team is to run the ball at least 51 times a game. Bang it in there, and then come with the special plays. Well, they've come with the special plays first and not really banged it in there very well.
I'll tell you one thing, though. Coach Bowden and the Seminoles have been here before. They're going to make it a football
game.
You're right. 2 quarters to go. Eric Thomas, the quarterback for Florida State from Georgia, never quarterbacked in a losing game in Little League in high school. He quarterbacked the Florida State freshman to a 5-0 season. His record as a starter is 6-1-1 coming into this. I think the Auburn game's the only game he ever started. They lost, and they lost by a point.
Well, the quarterback story is the Jackson kid, the freshman out of Georgia. When Todd Williams goes out with a hyperextended knee, Jackson has done a superlative job at quarterback in the first half.
Jackson really has. The big play of this game had to be that 50-yard pass he threw to Fred Lane that set up Georgia with a first and goal at the Florida State 4, and then they subsequently scored the first touchdown of the game.
I think the postscript to this football game will be that turnover after the 81-yard drive that Florida State got no points.
Kevin Butler is into the ball, and we're underway. Darren Holloman sprinting up the middle. And there's Bulldogs there to get him. John Brantley was down, and now Eric Thomas leads the Florida State offense back out. Art Baker is the offensive coordinator. See that Florida State has been a second-half team. A lot of teams from the South are because they're so well-conditioned from playing and training in the humidity. It's a warm day here today in Orlando, just like they like it. Chamber of Commerce weather.
Yeah, you see Rosie Snipes starting the second half with Hester and Jones at the wide receivers.
Pitch back to Snipes. The leading rusher turns up the sideline and gets across the 20-yard line, close to the 25. We'll see where they spot him out. Defensively, Georgia has played a magnificent game. They've kept the pressure on Eric Thomas when he's had to throw. They've shut down the run. They've been good all year long, but especially good today. In this game that Georgia wants so badly after closing the regular season with three straight losses after that 7-1 start. Chumley, defensive left tackle, 76, has played a big game. So have the linebackers, Knox and Mitchell, Knox Culpepper and Bill Mitchell, and Kevin Harris has been the star with two interceptions at the right corner. Second and five. Just a little bit up the middle. Cletus Jones, the fullback for the Seminoles, takes it to the 27.
Don, it looks like Florida State's intention here at the outset of the second half is to establish something at the line of scrimmage. Not be so tricky. Be a little more fundamental. They've got great speed, offensive weapons. They got to be used sparingly, though. And you've got to control that line of scrimmage to give Eric Thomas time to pass and keep those defensive linebackers, linemen and linebackers, out of Thomas's face, or no matter what you draw up, it ain't going to work.
Another thing, Trump, about those trick plays, there are low percentage, you know, the
yes.
wide receiver option throw, and when you do it, you'll the percentages hold up, you lose it down, and you all of a sudden you're in a hole again.
And I'll tell you another aspect. Psychologically, Georgia looks at Florida State and say, well, they're coming with trick plays. They think we're a great defense, and Georgia feeds off that. Florida State, on the other hand, says, wait a minute, we can't go with our bread and butter plays here. We're going trick plays. The coach has no confidence in us.
Third and less than a yard, and Eric Thomas calls number one, his own, and gets it straight ahead. He was bothered by a hip pointer, as I think you pointed out earlier, and wasn't running real well. He's just a good all-around athlete. He's big, strong, 6'1", 195 pounds. A junior from Lake Park, Georgia, heavily recruited by the Bulldogs, but he went to Florida State. Lake Park right near Valdosta, which is acknowledged as the number one high school team in America this year. First down through the run, and Snipes, not big but so quick and shifty, 5'9", 180, weaving behind his blockers. Gets by the front line of the Georgia defense and gets ahead for a gain of four. It'll be second down and six.
I'll tell you one thing, when Snipes gets a lot of yards, you got to give credit to those fullbacks in front of him, Cletus Jones, Cedric Jones. They're good blocking fullbacks. They'll take on a linebacker and allow Snipes a chance to get right by him.
Thomas fires and gets an end. Coming off the left flank is wide receiver Hassan Jones. A deep threat, 18-yard catch average this year for 28 receptions, 7 for touchdowns.
And just to show you how frustrating it must be for the Florida State Seminoles, that's Jones' first catch. He was one of their big play guys throughout the 84 season.
They're going to be throwing more to these great wideouts, though. The strength of this team is really Hester and Hassan Jones, two top pro prospects. Jones is just a junior. That was good for a first down. Up the middle, running hard is Cletus Jones, and the Dogs don't give him much. On a first down carry, they key on the up back and get him at the line of scrimmage.
Watch what happens here. You'll see the running back run right into his own man. You see the way those defensive linemen are catching still, just keeping him right at the line of scrimmage. That was Henry Harris, able to stand up the offensive lineman, and basically Jones had no place to run.
Jones, five runs now, 22 yards. Thomas takes a drop, stands in, throws on the run, and he gets his tight end. Pete Panton comes down with the ball on a well-thrown ball. Good for 13 yards and a Florida State first down. So the Seminoles, as you remember, they did their first possession in the first quarter, move right down the field, but that first drive today, they fumbled down close.
You can see the blitz coming. It's decently picked up by Florida State. A punt. Panton moves enough to get away from the linebacker, and then Bulls right over. Is that Sanchez, 31? Yes, Jeff Sanchez on the tackle. First down, Florida State. Big change in attitude here by Florida State. Wouldn't you agree?
I think the offense is a little bit more diverse right now. They're throwing basic pass patterns. Now here we go. And Snipes is gone. One man with a shot. Flack. Did Flack get him? He did. He knocked him out of bounds at the eight. Tony Flack got him, but Snipes had an open track to the end zone, and now after a 37-yard run on the pitch back, Florida State will go first and goal.
Snipes, for a guy 5'9", runs, has the stride of a guy about 6'3". He's very deceiving at the corner. And Don, this drive, they start the second half very conservative, nothing fancy, and this is generally the way Florida State plays. Now 7 carries, 57 yards by Snipes. He's had 3 straight 100-yard rushing days.
That was the big one, the 37-yarder, right back to the money, and Snipes cuts in, cuts out, and a nice tackle.
Ooh.
Jeff Sanchez, the All-American safety, saved a touchdown for Georgia, but for the moment.
Snipes may have turned his ankle a little bit there, too. You can see Sanchez rolling up the back of his leg. He's going to come out. Tony Smith is going to come in. Now watch the speed that he has coming out here. Watch Sanchez, 31, fights off the blocker, and then in desperation just dives at his legs. You can see he kind of gets his ankle twisted, and he's being helped off the field.
And Roosevelt Snipes needed aid to get off the field, so whether or not he'll be back and how soon remains to be seen. Tony Smith goes in his tailback. This is the 10th play of this sustained drive by the Seminoles, who trailed underdog Georgia 14-0 third quarter. Pitch back Smith.
Flag down.
Yep, marker is down at the line of scrimmage. This is where the Seminoles have been misfiring today, Trump.
They've gotten to this point before and turned it over to Georgia. Illegal procedure that can only be against the offense. So he'll take it back. Here's Bobby Bowden talking on the sideline. So I believe Art Baker calling the plays. Defensive captain Knox Culpepper will make the call. I would think they take the penalty.
Illegal motion signal. We remember when early in the game everyone was coached with hindsight. But Florida State turned down a penalty on a second and goal from the 9.
Offense, second down.
Took it third and goal from the 4, and Georgia took it in on the next play.
Florida State, 4-yard run, first touchdown of the afternoon. Now, there's no reason to be tricky here now again. Just stay with it, bang it in there.
Florida State down to the 11-yard line now, second and goal.
Georgia expecting the pass down. They're in the nickel package.
Expecting the right thing. Yep. Tip ball is caught by a lineman, Jamie Duke. That's ruled in it.
That's a completion.
A reception. Well,
yeah.
That's a loss of down then. He's an illegal receiver.
But only if he's
a fumbled ball, that's another thing.
Yeah. The ball has to be tipped in order for him to catch it. I don't believe it was.
Expensive penalty, loss of down.
Yeah. You can see Georgia once again coming with the blitz. And watch Thomas.
Does he throw? He does.
Well, that was kind of knocked out of his hand.
Yeah, he wasn't trying to get it to Jamie Dukes. Dukes showing very fine hands.
Touching the ball. Loss of down.
Yep.
Third down.
That hurts.
Illegal reception, so with 10:41 to play in the third quarter. The Seminoles, as they've done earlier, get down close. Mistakes force them back.
Okay, Georgia staying with the nickel package now, taking the timeout. Make sure they get the right people on the field. That gives Florida State a chance to catch their breath.
Eric Thomas wants a little counsel also, as he'll come back to action with a third and goal from the 16 coming up. Right after the 80 degrees and sunny in Orlando, Florida. Florida State trailing underdog Georgia 14-0, 10-16 to play in the third quarter in the Florida Citrus Bowl on NBC Sports. Kester's up on the right flank. Here's a throw. Hassan Jones goes for the ball. It's broken up beautifully by the man who's intercepted twice previously. Kevin Harris, cornerback for the Georgia Dogs.
He has played a whale of a game. Hassan Jones is a great leaper. This is well thrown by Eric Thomas. Jones had nowhere to go. No way to catch this. That's a good job.
Well, a real good job. He's been doing one all day. Kevin Harris could be headed for MVP honors with 2 interceptions in the breakup of what would have been a scoring throw. Now freshman kicker Derek Schmidt, who is in the top 10 in the nation among kickers with 93 points.
No,
it's the field goal.
Whoa, that was close, Tom.
Sure was. 32 yards out, the freshman from Sarasota gets favored Florida State its first points of the day. It's a 14-3 game, and we'll be back at the Citrus Bowl after this. Seminoles.
Rosie's trying to walk off a twisted ankle. You can see the new tape on that right ankle. They could certainly use his services. Young man with great speed. Missing Greg Allen, their All-American running back, Heisman Trophy candidate. Now they're three deep in that running back situation. Probably up to Tony Smith the rest of the day. There you can see the new tape on the right ankle.
Former Heisman Trophy candidate. Flutie won that thing by a plurality bigger than Reagan.
Yeah.
Now after the field goal, the kickoff. Knocked downfield by Barco. Into and out of the end zone, so the Dogs will go from their 20. Tomorrow, join us for a special show as NBC Sports rocks with Sports World's music videos. It's the Sports Year in Review, set to the songs of today's top groups. Sports World's music videos, it's all coming your way tomorrow. 1 o'clock Eastern time, America Loves Its Sports, NBC style. This is a terrific show. Really creative television.
Florida State's well placed, 66 yards, 4 minutes and 34 seconds. 32-yard field goal by Schmidt, but a missed opportunity.
Georgia on first down, not much there. Up the bottom of the pile is Gerald Nichols, the right tackle who upended the ball carrier. Freshman Cleveland Gary. Seminoles will be digging in, trying to get it back here.
Watch this offensive line of the Georgia Bulldogs.
Wow.
Stevens blew him out of there, didn't it? Ken Johnson still in there at center, number 61, even with his bad back. Whoops, whoops.
Another big play by the Seminole defense, Darryl Gray, an outside linebacker. Called on to start today, a surprise starter. Behind the line of scrimmage on second and eight, so now the Dogs have to go third and long.
Don, that's the same play we saw in the first half that resulted in about a 15-16-yard gain. Good escort, Pete Anderson, along with Jackson, but Florida State there to stop him.
Third and 12. Jackson gets out of trouble. Really gets out of it. James Jackson, bad ankle and all, outruns everybody for 25 yards and a Georgia first down.
The player, Fred Jones, finally on the tackle. The thing about this is there is no player on the field who is responsible for the quarterback. The whole defense is responsible for the quarterback. But once he gets by that line of scrimmage, you've got linebackers and defensive backs in coverage. Great speed by the Peanut, as Vince Dooley calls him. Looked like the ball got loose there. But
he can make big things happen fast. The 50-yard pass, and now the 25-yard run as they go back to it. Lars Tate takes the ball to the 45-yard line. A gain of 2 yards on the play will make it second down and eight.
We set up the ball game as the Florida State defense giving up several big plays. There you see. Last three possessions. Yes, sir.
Georgia, prior to that touchdown, had only scored 2 touchdowns in the previous 15 quarters, almost 4 games. They got 2 in the first half today.
Bob has made the comment that his defense gets a lot of offense as well.
Yeah, he said, don't worry. There's a free ball on the field. Florida State has it. Up the Seminoles and their big following here in Orlando. We'll see it again.
Paul McGowan, freshman on the recovery. This is a great hit. Let's see if we can see who makes it.
Taylor.
Henry Taylor jars that ball loose. 58. Whoa, 32. Excuse me. Martin Mayhew on the recovery. First turnover for the Bulldogs.
Weak side linebacker plays away from the tight end. Henry Taylor with great pursuit to come across and go to the ball as he did there. First down. Open field, running with the ball for Florida State is Cletus Jones, the fullback. Sanchez and Mitchell knocked him down. Now this game is turned up in the third quarter.
And can you see the difference? They're banging at the line of scrimmage. Trying to get some respect out of that Georgia defense.
The hitting will continue immediately following as NBC Sports goes to the Kingdome in Seattle for the AFC wildcard game between the Raiders and the Seahawks. Right now, Florida State down 14-3. Second in the yard. First back through, but there's a penalty marked down as Cletus Jones ran for the first down and more.
I think that's going to be defensive offsides.
Really?
Lined up in the neutral.
There you go. There you got lined up offside.
Yep.
Encroachment, as we say.
Yeah, no contact is encroachment. That's correct. And can you see the personality change? A little more emotion on the side of the field by Florida State. Now they're, I think they're exerting some pressure on Georgia, just being physical at the line of scrimmage. That's the character of the Florida State football team.
Offside, defense, first down.
You know what I like here? College football, they don't call numbers. I like that.
Spoken as an ex-player.
You got it, brother.
You heard number 84 a few times?
I have, at the most embarrassing moments.
First down and 10 for Florida State. 33-yard line, Eric Thomas. Nice pitch back. He gets it to Smith. Good defense by Georgia. They bang the quarterback. The pitch back. He got away somehow. And then Mitchell and Waters struck the running back, Tony Smith.
One of the ways you can destroy the option, and this is the option, is penetration. You can see 59 Waters right there just taking the choice away from the quarterback. 56 Billy Mitchell on that hit. And Waters cleans up on the outside. Well done. Well deep.
One play by the Bulldogs. That makes it second down and 10, so Thomas will be a pitching. He's got to hurry. Gets it away, and oh, his tight end had a step on the backer, but the pressure forced an overthrow. That brings up third down and 10. He's trying to go to Pat Carter, who he hit earlier, remember, for a first down.
Well, this has been a blitz down now for Georgia. Let's see if they come to it again. It also looks like let's count defensive backs here to see if Georgia goes with that nickel package that they run. One, two, three, four. No, they only got four. Standard defense.
Eric Thomas has the ability to run option to his left. Here he goes.
Whoa, no!
Option to his left, but nobody was there. Smith falls on it, but again, the Seminoles misfire when they had a big opportunity.
You called the play, Don. That's exactly what it was, and it looked like Tony Smith did not get the call. The rest of the offense played the option left. This is a blind pitch by the quarterback. And you say, wait a minute, bring that ball back here.
Oh, you want a string on that.
Are they lucky they got that back? Somebody will get yelled at on the sideline. Tony Smith is being talked to right now.
Jimmy Harrell back as a single safety now for Georgia. Lewis Ferry hits a high punt. And it come down inside the five. Again, a big special teams play by the Florida State Seminoles. A 42-yard punt, but most importantly, Pete Panton, the tight end covering, was able to down it at the one-yard line. Dogs get the ball, but they have a problem when they get it when we come back. ...has sent three teams to the playoffs. Join NBC Sports next when two of them, the LA Raiders, hook up against the Seattle Seahawks in the AFC wild card playoff game. The first step on the road to the AFC Championship. It's all next on NBC Sports. NFL 84 with host Bob Costas will start the day on Pro Football Side. Right now, we've got a lot of college action to go as Georgia tries to get out of a hole, and they go to the run. Andre Smith takes it out to the 3-yard line.
Florida State using a 5-man defensive front there, Don. They want to keep that ball down there. Keith Johnson, that huge offensive center of Georgia, getting up 6'5", 3'10".
Some of the cumulus nimbus.
Is that good or bad?
I'm not even sure if that's what they are, but it doesn't look too bad. No rain forecast. Sunny and 80 degrees. Trying to run as the penalty marker goes down. Look at these Seminoles play defenses. Jesse Salomon and Billy Allen come up on a penalty marker play.
Cleveland Gary coughed the ball up. Offsides defense. Boy, there have been some mental mistakes by Florida State today.
Came on a second and eight play, so they'll get the down over. It'll be second down and 3.
He had them where they wanted them. It would have been third down and about 8, as you said, Don. And gee whiz.
Defense, offsides, Second down.
So the ball set to the 8-yard line, and Georgia now with second down and just over two.
There's Bobby Bowden talking to Kirk Coker and Eric Thomas.
Got to believe they're going to go Trump to Hester and Hassan Jones.
Looks like he's drawn in the dirt over there.
You can't go to him until he gets the ball. There's a big play. Georgia's defense, our offense, unable to move the ball as Brian Williams shot the gap, got through to get the quarterback, James Jackson of Georgia.
Watch the line of scrimmage here. That's Keith Johnson, that huge offensive center. Stood up pretty good by the defense. You can't really see the number of the man that gets in there first. Brian Williams, it appears.
47. Georgia having a problem, as you see, with third down conversions, 35.
And watch that quarterback.
Jackson, he didn't get a thing. The Noles rise up, get their man.
Been an awful lot of pressure on this Florida State defense today, Don. More than they're used to.
They're used to being ahead. 35 points a game today. They have but three as we're starting to wind into the late portion of the third quarter. Chip Andrews into punt again. Punters have been very important people for both sides today. Andrews, a senior boomer in Sparta, Georgia, 45.4 yards a punt. This is senior year, ranked him among the nation's leaders. Line drive downfield. Darren Holloman will bring it back. Gets it inside the Georgia 40, down to the 38-yard line. A 7-yard return on a 39-yard punt. So Florida State, again, gets good field position thanks to the defense. Now, can the offense capitalize? We'll find out in a moment.
Grandpa Luke!
Up here, honey.
My friend.
Trumpy, this was not how they projected this game to go, Trump. They're looking for Florida State to get a lot of points. Georgia's defense has been strong.
Been a big surprise, but at least so far in the second half, the Seminoles are playing in character. This is a little more in their personality. Control that line of scrimmage.
Down 14-3. Thomas firing. Jet Hester makes a diving reception at the 30-yard line. They got the blue chippers on the flanks. They have to get the ball to them.
Well, they're also getting soft coverage now out of the Bulldogs secondary because Florida State's been able to run the ball a little bit. I think that was their intention at the outset of this ball game. They couldn't accomplish it, and that's an audible. You'll see the quarterback go to his face mask, and then it's a quick out.
Second down and two. First back through was Cletus Jones, the 220-pound fullback, normally a blast blocker, but he averaged over 5 yards a carry this year. Chief Osceola, he's ready to fire that spear, maybe right into the hook of the dog.
Yeah, they may need it before this ball game is over. It'd be a penalty, but it'd get somebody's attention.
Riding the good horse Renegade.
Yes, there.
There's the dog.
Like his collar, he's very fashionable today.
Dogs that bite, they say, are on the defense. And they're teeing off now, ready to come after Florida State as the Seminoles starting to challenge inside the 30. Thomas, this time he makes sure he's got Smith back there. And it turns into a good gainer. Gary's down to the 20. It'll bring up short yardage for the first down.
First time we've seen that formation. Two tight ends, a wide receiver to this side of the field. They run the option. Guard pulls. Option teams call that a load. They option off Loy, number 39, pitch it to Smith. And you need some blocking on the outside. Hester got one, and it's a first down.
Eric Thomas, a very versatile athlete. He'll option right or left and throw the ball. This time he goes to the first back through. The fullback, Cedric Jones, runs the ball. Donald Chumley knocks him down for Georgia.
Culpepper, we haven't called his name much in this second half. You see a good double team by Dukes and Ionata. He's there to make the tackle. Sometimes when Georgia plays, people up in Georgia say there's more than 148 out there. He seems to make all the tackles.
His dad, the late Knox Culpepper, was a captain of Georgia. Knox Culpepper on the field now, had team record 26 tackles against Georgia Tech this year.
Ooh, that's busy.
Pitch back to Tony Smith. First down carry is good for maybe 2 yards before Chumley, who's playing a big game at defensive tackle for the Dogs, knocks him down.
Chumley tripped him up. Well, let's see if Florida State at this point on the field now can function without making just a dumb mental mistake. An offsides, an illegal formation or illegal procedure has just killed him today.
Tell you, Bobby Bowden had to age when he saw that pitchback and no trailer on the play to get it.
Whoa.
That stopped the drive. Now it's second down and 10. No gain the last time.
Going for low.
Hassan Jones.
No.
Oh, man, close. Good-looking play, but one foot wasn't in.
Kevin Harris once again in coverage. He's the guy who's come up with two interceptions. They've tested him all day long. Watch his feet. One in. No way. Good call by the official. That right foot came down on the white. That is out of bounds. That's clearly a good call by the official.
Thomas now 8 of 19 on the passing day. 71 yards and the two interceptions.
11 seconds left in the third quarter. Florida State has not scored a touchdown.
Florida State dominating the third quarter from a possession standpoint, but has scored only 3 points. At halftime, Georgia, the underdog, led 14 to nothing. First time Florida State and Georgia have played since 1965. This is the ninth meeting overall. Georgia won the first five, Florida State the last four. Well, some of these people weren't even around the last time they played.
Yeah, you know, the best play they've had so far today has been a reverse. The receivers are too wide to run a reverse. That's not going to happen here.
Pitch back. Good play. Smith looking to the end zone. Puts his head down and gets a first down during nearly a touchdown. Tony Smith, the 5'9", 175-pound junior tailback from Miami, made a mistake earlier, but now comes up with the big run, finally knocked down by Harris.
15 yards on the carry, and one of the reasons it works, Knox Culpepper not there to make the tackle. Good play by Ionata, and that's that hesitation in the backfield by the quarterback and the running back. That gives the offensive lineman position on those linebackers to make a block like that.
What's up front that counts? And big John Ionata from Dunedin, Florida, junior tackle, chopped down Culpepper, and now it's first and goal for the Seminoles.
Hey, we got a meeting of the officials on the sideline here. I wonder if they're possibly talking about, oh, there was 11 seconds left in the third quarter, and suddenly there's 21-20. Now they're getting it down to the right time. Up to this point, Florida State, the second half, played very well, but they've gotten down in this area and then made the dumb mistake.
If the Seminoles don't get it in here, they might fold the tent. It hurts when you get down.
You're right. This will be their third time if they don't get it in the end zone. Within inside the 10-yard
right.
line.
It is. Third time.
That can beat you up mentally.
And each time with a first down.
Excellent point. There's Vince Dooley.
Well, they wind the clock out.
Yeah.
The Bulldogs head upfield, putting four fingers in the air. Fourth quarter's our quarter, they say. And so said the Seminoles. We'll be right back after these messages from your local station.
Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? By IBM. By Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. And by GTE. Advancing technology in telecommunications and electrical products.
The live action now. Florida State going inside the 2-yard line, the fullback. Cletus Jones tries the middle of the Georgia defense, didn't get there. But the Seminoles with three more downs. There is a critical loss. Roosevelt Snipes, starting tailback for the Seminoles, out with an ankle injury.
Got a big ice bag on it, shoulder pads off. That's obviously a bad sign, start the fourth quarter.
You can tell how badly he wants to be there. Right down near the payoff. Game evening up statistic-wise, but Georgia still with the dominance on the scoreboard, leading 14-3.
You like the option here?
Looks like it. There's the lead blocker, but it goes the other way, and Smith is into the end zone. Touchdown Seminoles, and it's tightened up. Tony Smith.
Excellent job by the Florida State offensive line. A
allowing Smith to cut back. When you run a play like this, you need somebody to cut off that pursuit from the inside. As you see Mitchell trying to get through there, and Waters trying to get through there. He cuts back, and there's basically no one to make the tackle. Now watch Mitchell try to get through the tackle. And he's got to go in the end zone to get to the ball carrier, and that's a great job. And Florida State goes for two.
That's a strong 175 pounds, too. Tony Smith taking on the tackles, going for two indeed. Option open. Eric Thomas is going to get nowhere near the goal line, so it's a 14-9 game. And they take the extra point. They still need a touchdown. And they need the two-point conversion. They'd have been down by six and conceivably could have won it with a touchdown and an extra point.
This is the straight option. The dive. He chooses to stay with it. Jeff Sanchez, All-American. Strong safety, makes the tackle.
Five-point difference now. Bobby Bowden, the coach of the Seminoles, his team back in at 14-9. Bobby Bowden, when he was 19, and his girlfriend, a high school cheerleader, she was 16, eloped. 35 years later, he and Ann are still happily married. He said, got a $20 speeding ticket, was the best money he ever spent. Getting across the state line to marry her.
Hey, Don, I got one for you. The starting quarterback for Georgia, James Jackson, is back to return this kickoff.
Fred Lane's back there with him. Interesting combination. They hooked up on that 50-yard pass play that set up the game's first touchdown for Georgia.
And I remember, if he catches the ball and runs to his right or left, he can throw it backwards.
We're going to get into that now, the lead. They got no shot at it anyway.
Out to the 30. Through the end zone.
Barry Barco, who's the kickoff man, the sophomore, drills it through the end zone on the fly, so the Dogs come out to take over the ball, first and 10 on their 20.
You know, you were talking about Bobby Bowden. He's walked about 150 miles this afternoon up and down that sideline. Here's the Georgia possessions in the second half, vastly different from the first half. We're going to have a good finish to this football game.
If Bobby Bowden ever wanted to get out of coaching, he could sure make it as a speaker.
Don't mention that. Oh, I thought you were going to say a sportscaster. Don't mention that too much. I was going to say.
Jackson throws, and he's got his man, the tight end, Scott Williams. He's going to keep going, even though he's out of bounds.
Brian McCrary on the coverage. The one thing Florida State want right there is just simply a good defensive stand. Make it take some time. 36 yards on the catch. Nobody in coverage. Jackson threw it very well. Now, I'm not sure who you put the hat on here for the coverage, but watch how open he is. He's behind everybody. There's nobody there in coverage whatsoever. Finally, McCrary gets him out. 15 is Anthony Smiley.
To live action, here come the Dogs on the run, and going hard is Tron Jackson, who's been quiet for a while, getting a call from scrimmage on first down. He rockets ahead and gets it down close to the 26-yard line.
This guy's got great speed. Runs 100 yards and 10-3. Big kid, too.
He was the South Carolina state champion in both 100 and 200 meters. He gets the opening. He can be gone. Almost was there. Got eight as it was. Georgia driving, leading by five in the fourth quarter with 13:15 to play in the game.
That's first down. Well, Georgia suddenly coming alive. The Florida State defense gets a rest, and they seem to just go to sleep out there.
It's really great to see what an enterprise like a bowl game does for a whole community. We'll be going down next week to the Orange Bowl, where you get some great people, important people. Everybody in South Florida gets behind the Orange Bowl and makes it an event, a civic statewide happening. Doing the same thing here in Orlando with the Citrus Bowl.
98% too are volunteers.
Sold out in the Shriners Hospital are the beneficiaries as Lars Tate runs the ball hard inside the 20 on a first down carry. Lars Tate has been the payoff man for Georgia. He's been in the end zone for both touchdowns.
Henry Taylor, the most consistent linebacker for Florida State, hesitates a little. He's there to make the tackle. I like that kid.
Boy, he can really play. Bowden says he plays every down of practice, scrimmages, like it's the...
Well, they need a big defensive play right here. They Georgia is certainly in Butler's range, but they need a big play right there to stop this drive.
Linebacker's playing off, pitch back, Tate goes wide, and they get the big play. As Tate comes across, this time it was the other inside backer, Fred Jones. Sophomore from Miami, stuffing the run.
Once again, Henry Taylor from behind the play tries to make the tackle. He runs up through the offensive line of scrimmage, and it's just the speed of Lars Tate and a last-second block by Anderson keeps Taylor out of the play.
Florida State's defense has allowed only one runner all season long to gain 100 yards against them.
Let's see, what has Georgia done that's worked for him in crucial situations? I look for Jackson right here.
I'll tell you, Jackson doing anything that's wide open. Rolling out, firing deep. Jackson, quarterback draw off a drop. He's a real athlete with tremendous speed, playing with a supposed bad ankle.
And if Georgia wins this ball game, even though they lost the last three regular season games of the season, Vince Dooley will have found a quarterback that's active and mobile and also won a football game. So this is a big plus for Georgia.
The Florida Citrus Bowl is sponsored by the Florida Citrus Commission and the Florida Citrus Growers, with the people of Orlando and Orange counties backing it, benefiting the 22 Shrine hospitals around the country.
Thanks for the great time down here. All those people, everybody. Did you like
Kings? Do it right.
Yeah.
And the Orange Bowl ain't a bad one either. Only great. That's next week on NBC Sports.
You got that right.
Along with the Fiesta and the Rose, all coming up New Year's Day. Culminating with the final game of the college season. Another super matchup between the Sooners of Oklahoma, number two in the country, and the Huskies of the University of Washington, number three in the coaches' poll. Right now, we have the Georgia Bulldogs holding to a five-point lead with a third down problem.
I don't know what the holdup is. The officials are waiting for something to happen. They're not sure what. Clock seems to be all right. They'll get it straightened out.
Since James Jackson came in the first quarter, Trump, he's accounted for almost 200 yards. He's passed for 138 yards and rushed for 40.
Resetting the clock as best they can. Wait a minute. They don't have the clock set right here. Somebody should stop the play. They got 19 seconds left. Okay.
Swing pass. Don Jackson. Oh. Big defensive play. He had a track open. Henry Taylor, number 58, was again the man.
That was the defensive play of the game. He fought through two guys to get to Tron Jackson and make the tackle. This is well disguised by Jackson. I like this kid, even with the lack of experience. Now watch Taylor come from out of your left. Look at there. Blocked by Anderson. Still there to make the tackle. Ball is loose. Goes out of bounds. Butler on for a field goal.
Tron Jackson had an open lane. Now as Butler comes out, if he hits it, it'll present an interesting dilemma for Florida State.
Don't be offside.
They'll be down by eight. They need a touchdown and a two-point conversion just to tie.
Chip shot.
Penalty markers down there. Other than roughing.
Yeah, that's running into the kicker. Once again, Joe Wessel has made a mistake on a kick. That's a major penalty. It'll be a first down. Watch this. Third time this has happened. Running into the kicker.
The way this has gone with turnovers, I'd take the three into the eight-point lead.
No, you can't do that. The coaches are saying decline the.
Say that.
You're right. Vince Dooley is saying decline the penalty. We will take the 3 points. You know, that's a half a distance to the goal penalty.
That's a sure thing. They know they've got an 8-point lead in the fourth quarter if they take the field goal. And that's what Coach Dooley says to do. Well, let's not take points off. We haven't had that many lately.
Yeah, you're right. I want to remind you of the 2-point conversion and the success the offense has had, Florida State's offense, in the second half.
Well, a lot more to go, and we'll be back at the Florida Citrus Bowl right after this.
Sat down with Mom, talked to
her. We're ready for the artful Joe Wessel and his kick blocking. They've stopped him, but a couple of times he's run into the kicker after it.
Yeah, he's done most of that himself. I still question his choice, John. That's a major penalty.
Georgia would have had the ball half the distance to the goal. First down. Now the penalty is assessed on the kickoff. 3 points is certainly good. There's no question about that, but Florida State still within reach with a two-point conversion after a touchdown.
Well, I think it's more than 3 points. I think it's an eight-point lead in the fourth quarter.
Well, but that can still be matched, though, with a touchdown and the two-point conversion. Interesting choice.
Well, the choice is history. Right now, they're going to kick it off. The penalty assessed. So Butler will kick it off. Look at, he's lining up. He's going to try something. What's he going to do here?
Onside kick.
I wouldn't think that'd be too. Got it. Free ball.
Florida State got it. Good field position.
Well, that's unusual. Have you seen that before? You have a lead in the fourth quarter. You try an onside kick.
Okay, but you've got a 15-yard penalty, so you kick it from the other team's 45-yard line. And this is the penalty that started. This is the third penalty on kicks against Joe Wessel today. You want a kid to try, give his level best. Joe has just been a little over-anxious today. He's hurt his team. His last game as a Seminole, he wanted it to turn out better than this time.
But he sure helped them previously with the kick blocks, and now the Seminoles go to the run on first down. Latis Jones runs the ball and gets it out to the 30.
Stadium clock is not working. I'd venture to say there's, what, 9 minutes left? I would think this would be a very conservative drive by Florida State. There's the clock. Not working. Kept on the field. Very conservative drive. And try to get this ball in the end zone. Go for the two-point conversion.
Clock went out. Time being kept down the field. The Seminoles of Florida State in their garnet and goal looking for a big play now. Eric Thomas looking deep. Fires. He's got a man. Jeff Hester coming across the middle. He's up to the 40. It's a first down, Florida State. Jesse Jet Hester. Not big, 6 feet, 170, but about as fast as they get.
And that Bill Mitchell on the tackle again. That guy's been everywhere today. It's a good high percentage pass if you've got pass protection. That time Florida State protected him well. Thomas didn't throw it too well, but Hester made the catch.
And it was good for a first down. So now Florida State trailing in the game 17-9. We're waiting to get an official read on what the time remaining is. Blocks out. Thomas keeps it himself and does well. Breaks it across the 50. Down to the 49-yard line. 11-yard gain and a first down.
Tom, we just heard there's 12-10 left in the ball game.
A lot of time left. And a lot of pressure on the favored Seminoles. They need a touchdown and a two-point conversion just to tie. You'll recall they went for a two-point conversion after their first touchdown, their only touchdown. And it was stuffed. They didn't get there.
Georgia wants to win because the last time a Bulldog team lost four in a row was 1963, the year before Vince Dooley took over as the head coach.
Thomas throws a good strike. He gets it inside the 45-yard line of Georgia, delivering the ball to Hassan Jones, who came off the right flank.
Mitchell and John Little on the tackle. Little, the rover back. You see a lot of people coming in and out of the lineup now for Georgia. I think Vince Dooley gave his starters just a little breather there for this drive, this very critical drive.
Coach Dooley himself was a quarterback at Auburn as a collegian.
Georgia's offside, Don. Look at that defensive tackle.
He is. He's over the ball.
They threw the flag, too.
They did.
Oh, don't it. You know, you work so hard that
they're going to
keep a team from going in the end zone, and then you do dumb little things like that. Offsides, defense, and it gives them a first down.
Couldn't give them a first down if they take it. Be close to one now. They almost got the first down with the carry. Would make it second down and about one.
It was Henry Harris, number 52, that was up there cheating for inches when you don't need inches in a defense like that.
So the Seminoles take the penalty.
Defense offside.
Well, you had it, Trump. They lined up right over the ball. That arm was across the ball.
And that's just a lack of concentration. I mean, the ball is 3 feet from him.
The official time is being kept on the field.
Florida State gets the down over. Second down again, but this time only one. Maybe we'll see Thomas put it up. Darren Holloman of Flyers on the left flank. Marson Jones on the right. They go to the run and get the first down. Cletus Jones, the fullback, takes it straight ahead. They went right after big Donald Chumley, some good offensive blocking.
Well, a few times today they put him on the ground. He's done an excellent job. Ionata Hanton, the tight end and offensive tackle. I repeat, Don, it's a very conservative drive here by Florida State. High percentage passes, trying to hang on to that football.
9 minutes and change remaining. We're waiting for another read on the clock. Scoreboard clock is out. We're in the fourth quarter. Underdog Georgia leads Florida State. In with the ball, 17-9.
Whoa.
Eric Thomas didn't have time to get it away. Henry Harris had a moment to spare. Saw the quarterback start to roll and shed the block and made the knockdown.
Yeah, ran right behind the block at the center and was there before Thomas could make up his mind to do anything.
Between them, Hester and Jones have combined for only 5 catches and total yardage of 37.
Came into the game averaging about 19 yards a catch between the two of them. Those possessions, all Florida State scoring in the second half.
Second and long, second and 13. Here's a throw, and it's almost intercepted by Bill Mitchell. Junior linebacker from Dalton, Georgia, has made a lot of plays today for the Dogs.
Sure has. Those linebackers, this ball should not have been thrown. When Thomas is looking right into the sun, that may have had an effect, but there's two guys there to make the interception. If he doesn't make it, the rover back does, John Little.
Hit him in that proverbial bad place.
Well, he's got his hands taped, gloves. Little had a better chance.
Third down now coming up and 13. Hester's on the left flank. That's where they're looking. But he'll never get it away as again a big rush comes from Georgia 99. Jake Richardson is there to knock down Eric Thomas. So the Georgia defense rises up again.
They have made big plays all day long. Jake Richardson comes from almost crawling on the ground to get to him. There you see him coming into the picture. He does a smart thing there. He gets both legs in his arms, not just one.
Sophomore Lewis Berry in to punt the ball again. Gets off a good one, long. Jimmy Harrell looks at it and fair catches at the 10. So Georgia, holding to a 17-9 lead, gets the football back. They'll try to run the clock when we come back to the Florida Citrus Bowl in Orlando.
Everybody's coming to the Johnsons for the holidays.
He's 59 yards, but out with a bad ankle. Hook 'em horns, is that what he's saying? We're at 7:40 left in the fourth quarter now. There it is. 7:50 left in the fourth quarter.
Scoreboard clock has been out through much of the fourth quarter. Georgia holding a lead, looking to hold the ball as they go to the running game. Tron Jackson turns the corner. Diving across the 15-yard line, he got to the 17. The linebacker Jesse Solomon knocked him down.
Georgia's done an excellent job in critical situations of capturing that corner of the Florida State defense and allowing Tron Jackson and also Tate to get outside, get turned upfield with their speed. That's instant yards.
Double wide receiver formation to the left now for Georgia. And second and 3, they go back short side of the field and they get the first down. Right back to Jackson, the sprinter, 170 pounds, who came in averaging over 6 yards a run.
Jesse Solomon again on the tackle.
7 minutes and 10 seconds left to play. Eric Thomas, the FSU quarterback, hoping to get back in there soon with the offense.
Ball just inside the 25-yard line.
Jackson, a freshman quarterback, came out when the starter Todd Williams was injured in the first quarter. He sprained a knee. Jackson has really been the prime mover for the Georgia Bulldogs. Leading the 2 first half touchdowns, now to a 17-9 lead over favored Florida State.
With the little experience he possesses at a quarterback, and he's done a marvelous job for Georgia. That's certainly a plus for Vince Dooley and his staff to start the 1985 season. That young man,
He had a bad ankle all week, was limping in practice.
Yeah. He's got well in a hurry, didn't it?
Lame get well for big games. We saw him a short time ago after Florida State scored. Back to take the kickoff back.
Yeah.
Second and nine. Jackson got it right on the numbers of Anthony Quincy, number 89, coming down with the ball. And Georgia gets a first down.
19 yards on the catch. Turned his back to the defense. Here's Quincy on the pattern. Brian McCrary on the coverage. See him trying to be rerouted. 32 up front. Martin Mayhew tries to route him. Oh, that's well thrown. What an offensive MVP. You certainly got to look at Jackson. Surprising performance.
Playing like a veteran. Now he goes to the run, hands off, and he goes to Tron Jackson. No relation. Ron Jackson takes it across the 45 out to the 48. Got about three on first down.
Don, the thing I like about Jackson, James Jackson, to this point, the quarterback, is that he's not made the mistake that you would generally think a freshman quarterback might have. That's the thing that impresses me the most. He's played today like he's been out there for a long time, and in fact, he hasn't.
We're coming up on 5.5 minutes to play, and also remember that Georgia has the long ball kicker in Kevin Butler, the fourth leading scorer in NCAA history. The Dogs run the clock and run the ball as they get it down close to another first down. That second and seven carry was good for about 4 yards. Better now where they spot the ball. It's going to be third down and just over a yard coming up. The leading scorer in NCAA history is Luis Zendejas, senior place kicker for Arizona State. Tony Dorsett is number two all time. Another Heisman Trophy winner from years ago, Glenn Davis of Army fame, is number three, and Kevin Butler number four, all-time NCAA scoring leaders. Pitch back, Tron Jackson.
Oh, big start.
Third down, and the Seminoles again make a big play on defense. Fourth down comes up.
Henry Taylor, Billy Allen, there to make the stop.
Billy Allen, a tough customer from Cleveland, Ohio, comes up to make the first hit.
Even though the lead blocker, Andre Smith, is out there, Taylor from the inside, Mayhew, and Allen all there to stop Georgia before the first down.
Chip Andrews, the very good punter on the field now for the Dogs. Clock has to be inside 4 minutes. Scoreboard clock has been out the whole fourth quarter. Darren Holloman again back. They're confident in this freshman. A little return man standing back at his 10.
Georgia taking the illegal procedure. Delay of game. Penalty. Get back 5 yards, and that's no problem to Andrews.
Use all the time they can.
Sure, absolutely.
So the ball is set back now to the Georgia 49-yard line. 4:05 remaining in the game. Time being kept on the field now. This is the Florida Citrus Bowl on NBC Sports. Don Cricky with Bob Trumpy in Orlando, Florida. Boomtown in the Sun Belt. The game sold out. The Bulldogs of Georgia holding to a 17-9 lead over favorite Florida State. They blocked it. Wessel's going to pick it up and go in. This will be a Florida State touchdown. His fourth return for a touchdown this year. He's missed a lot of times, Trump.
You got to feel good for the guy, too. We've been on his case all day long. Three penalties really cost the team field position and drives extended by Georgia. But I'll tell you what, Russell doesn't give up, and the guy in the middle is the one who touched Lenny Chavers.
That's his fourth block.
That's right. Russell picks it up to run it in. The Florida State defense has now blocked 9 punts for 11 TDs, along with field goals.
There it is again. Right up the middle comes Chavers, and then Joe Wessel is there to field the ball. The 2-point conversion.
Reverse.
It is a reverse to Darren Holloman. He's going in. The game is tied. Yo!
the Florida Citrus Bowl right after this with over 3 minutes to play.
You're looking at a prime example of the new forward thinking at Ford. A family sedan conceived and created to change your thinking about family sedans. Its name, Ford Tempo. With front wheel drive for sure-footed traction. It's a family sedan that doesn't look or act like one. Front wheel drive Ford Tempo, the forward thinking car. Have you driven the best built American cars? Have you driven a Ford lately?
What do a zipper company in Pennsylvania, a gear manufacturer in Michigan, and a nationwide shoe corporation have in common?
Outside, he doesn't get it. Lenny Chavers blocking his fifth punt. And I repeat, the special teams of Florida State has accounted for 10 touchdowns. That's the 6 points. The two-point reverse, an outstanding play. It looks like the option. Holloman coming the other way.
Great-looking play.
And he makes a great move on the inside to get at the end zone. This kid is not big at all, but he ran like a big kid
that
there.
That took some timing to get that one off right. And a great second look. NBC technicians again doing a superlative job. Our producer, Peter Rolfe. Our director, Richard Klein, as we are now tied in the fourth quarter.
And Georgia expecting the onside kick.
With Butler, I don't know if you want to do that. Now they deliver it downfield. They had the hands team in. They did. Harrell, the only deep back. He downs it in the end zone.
Touchback.
They had a wave off those Seminoles coming. They thought he might have taken it outside.
You can hear the boos. He had 1 foot in the end zone and 1 foot out on the playing surface. And some of the Florida State people said, wait a minute. That's a safety. Not so. Once you break the plane in the end zone, you're in the end zone.
Jack Nicklaus of professional golf fame is here. His son is one of the wide receivers for Florida State. Steve Nicklaus, who's a junior receiver, hasn't been in yet. He's an All-State player in Florida. Burt Reynolds, the number one Florida State fan, couldn't make it to the game. Just endowed the School of Theater with $1 million.
Watch what that turnover does to the defense now of Florida State.
Jackson had adrenaline pumping. This little guy can throw fastballs, but that one was too high.
Fred Lane, the intended receiver. Florida State's going to get this ball back.
Looking for that time again. The clock has been out the whole fourth quarter, the official time being kept on the field. Scoreboard clock is official in the National Football League, not in college football. It's kept on the field. They've seen clocks go out before.
All over the place.
Here he goes. Jackson hitting out. Turns the corner. And a big defensive play by Billy Allen, the strong safety. Stopping the first down attempt.
Boy, that kid is a threat. Allen showed great speed there, too.
He sure did, a 2-10, running that little Jackson down.
You can account for everybody down there who's an eligible receiver, but as a defense, you cannot account for this guy. Allen, a great individual effort. 6 carries now for Jackson, 45 yards. Third and how much? 4?
NBC statistician Ross Schneiderman showing Jackson now at 45 yards, running the ball on 6 carries. Handoff. Boy, the chain markers become very important now. It looked like Florida State might have stopped that third down attempt.
That was Andre Smith on the carry. It does appear that he stopped short. I guarantee you this is when coaches earn their money. This is a good job by Florida State getting across that line of scrimmage. 79, Gerald Nichols just misses him. I think he's short. Do you go for it? Tell you what, I got to admire Vince Dooley. We're not going for any ties here.
Nope.
We're going for a win on both sides. I like that.
Game is tied, 17-17. We're down close to 2 minutes. Fourth down in less than a yard.
One more.
Seminoles have the ball. Penalty marker is down. Is this a good one or what? against Georgia. That's the preliminary signal.
Don, that's the first mistake that kid's made all day long. In case you're wondering,
he said delay of game?
Yeah, that's what the signal was.
How about that?
We got some Seminoles over here on the warpath.
In case you're wondering, Derek Schmidt, the field goal kicker for Florida State, has made a 54-yard field goal. He is 7-9 from 40 to 49 yards.
The officials whistled that play dead. Looked like a trick play, but it wasn't.
No. Georgia went for it on fourth down.
Yeah, that's right.
And now they're getting another play here. Wait a minute.
20 remaining, we're told.
Now, if this happens to Bobby Bowden in the state of Florida, he's going to have somebody's head.
2:20 left in the game. 2 minutes, 20 seconds.
There's been some historic fifth down snuck in over the decades in the pro college
game.
They
went for it on fourth down. The marker was fourth down.
Yes, it was. They stopped him.
Now, what they're saying is, because of the penalty, they get the down over, and therefore it's fourth again, and they do have the right to punt.
Well, we'll be back before they resume action again as we take this pause. He didn't count. The 5 yards is assessed, and now on fourth down, Georgia ready to punt again in a tie game with 2:20 to play. The Florida Citrus Bowl coming down to the final gun. Florida State getting a crack at it. This could be a last at bat game. Look at the hit on Darren Holloman. He's not tough. Bounces up like a greyhound, and off the field he goes. Fortunately, did not fumble.
22, Tony Mangrum. 33, Bill O'Leary. And he hung on to the football. 42 yards on the catch. This is what you call your zero return yardage.
Those are the kind that start to hurt. Tony Mangrum down there with Bill O'Leary. Georgia's dogs have come up with big plays all day long on defense. They'll be trying to now, as the Seminoles will work to get in field goal range. A tie game late in the fourth quarter. Look at the dogs fight here.
Busted play, Don. That's the fifth sack of the day for Georgia, as you see on the screen. That's a busted play. Eric Thomas had nobody to throw it to. Watch him looking around here, Don. Somebody ran the wrong pattern, did something wrong, because Thomas was, he was looking for help, trying to find that safety net, the life raft. Somebody out there with a friendly jersey to throw it to.
Remember that Georgia has the long-range kicker. Kevin Butler beat Clemson this year with a 60-yarder that he booted between the hedges.
And he had plenty of room to spare.
Less than 2 minutes to go now. Coach Bowden and the Seminoles fighting from behind, down 14-0 at the half. Then down 17-9, they rallied back. A block punt. The subsequent pickup and score by Joe Russell, the two-point conversion, and the pitch back to Holloman, and the game is tied 17-17. Eric Thomas tries to run against Georgia, but gets very little on a second down and 18 after the sack.
Well, you got an interesting choice here now. It's going to be third down and about 15, maybe 14 yards. You would think under normal circumstances this is two-down area, but with Kevin Butler, you can't give him the ball in this area because he can kick the field goal.
Quarterback Eric Thomas has run the ball 9 times and has gained only 1 yard.
Reverse again.
Whoa, look at this. Look at the Georgia dogs coming, throwing down inside the 10-yard line. Greg Waters, 59, was through.
Fool me once, you're a fool. Fool me twice, I'm a fool. He's no fool. They got him on the two-point conversion.
The dogs do it right that time, and now they'll force a Florida State punt.
That first time they ran the reverse went for 31 yards. They got up on it now.
We'd like to take time out to thank all the fine people involved with the Florida Citrus Bowl for all their help in the coverage of today's game, with special thanks to the executive director of the Florida Citrus Bowl, Chuck Rowe, the assistant executive director, Dylan Thomas, the executive producer, John Fole, and the administrative assistant, Carol Monroe. We'll be back for the conclusion right after this. Left to go. Georgia will get the ball back in this tie game, 17-17.
punt is on the way. And it goes out to midfield and it's down there. And so with just over a minute to play, the Georgia Bulldogs get the football back. We'd also like to thank the people with both Georgia and Florida State who've been such a big help. The University of Georgia Athletic Director and Head Coach Vince Dooley, Sports Information Director Claude Felton, Florida State Athletic Director Hootie Ingram, Head Coach Bobby Bowden, and Sports Information Director Wayne Hogan. For their help in the booth, NBC statistician Ross Schneiderman, spotters Donna Turner of Florida State, and Bob Beeler of Georgia.
We got the stars of the game here. Most valuable player, James Jackson, quarterback, Georgia. Offensive player of the game, Lars Tate, running back, Georgia. Defensive player of the game, Kevin Harris, cornerback, Georgia.
One minute to go. Georgia working to get in position for a field goal. Jackson dropping to throw. A strike. It's intercepted by Joe Wessel. Perfect throw, and it went right through his hands. Joe Wessel, who scored the last touchdown for the Seminoles after he picked up the block punt, now intercepts the ball, and Seminoles try again to get in range.
He started off this game rather shaky. He certainly made up for it, hadn't he? Once again, not a mistake by Jackson. Ball should have been caught. 40 seconds left. Wessel gets it.
Going to Jimmy Hockaday. He couldn't hold it here as Eric Thomas throwing on the run. Almost picked off the other way by Andy Loy. A great game at the Florida Citrus Bowl, and another one coming up on NBC Sports. We'll be going right to the Kingdom in Seattle as the Raiders and the Seahawks hook up in the AFC wild card game. That's next today on NBC Sports.
In case you're wondering, no overtime. 35 seconds left.
Also, our thanks to the president of the Florida Citrus Bowl Committee, John Lord, incoming president Manny Garcia, to Joe Cantrell. Been a big success and a big enterprise undertaken by the people in this part of the country to make it work. And here's a throw downfield as the ball is incomplete at the 50. We'll keep going to the sideline trying to get the official time. Scoreboard clock has been out for the whole fourth quarter. We're under a minute to play, though. Well under it. Benches are being informed after each player they should be.
They will be by the officials, yes. Although there's only one guy on the field with the official clock.
28 seconds left.
Chumley.
Dogs come through again. Donald Chumley was the first man through to stop Eric Thomas. The sixth sack of this game of Thomas by the Georgia defense.
Timeout taken.
Might end in a standoff. Florida State a long way from field goal range and fourth down coming up. They send the punting unit out.
Or do they?
Yep.
Yeah, they send them out, but do they punt?
Well, the problem is if you don't make it go, Butler's going to come right in.
You're right. I don't think they have much choice, and I think that's the disappointment on the face of Bobby Bowden. They not only need a punt, they need a darn good punt here to keep it out of Butler's range.
Trump the Clemson game revisited.
61 yards. They credited him with 60, but it was actually over 60 yards. He's had a virus all week. There he is, number 5, standing on the sideline. That's his holder right there.
This could be like Rocky II for Kevin Butler. He Clemson with a 60-yarder, and Florida State is going to really have to cover this kick. 21 seconds left. Kick down the field and at the 46-yard line. John Lord, the president of the Florida Citrus Bowl Commission, was talking about how they've upped the prize money. It's up to $600,000 a team. 4 years ago, I think it was something like $100,000 a team. Next year, it's going up to $1.5 million. The two will split.
Well, they keep playing games like that. There'll be a lot of people down here paying a lot of money to see this. As it
If Butler would try right there, that would be a, am I correct, 63-yard attempt, 7 yards plus 10 for the end zone.
You got it. Mississippi State coach says it's discouraging when they get the ball in the 20 to get a first down and field goal range. Downfield, Cassius Osborne sprinting for the ball and can't get to it.
There's Butler.
The clock has been out the whole fourth quarter, so we have to get reports on the field and how much official time is left. There's about 10 seconds left.
How much time, he's asking. Finding out how much time. Doing some research on Kevin Butler of Georgia. He has scored 14 points kicking in three games this season.
Kevin Butler, 79% of his career field goals have been made. Only 21 misses and 10 of those have been over 50 yards. There's a long ball down. This might be picked off by Wessel. Now he was getting out of bounds anyway. Well, here he comes. Super late. Kevin Butler. This will be his all-timer if he hits this.
Now, we did a tape with him earlier in the week. He said he doesn't watch the kick. He lets the crowd tell him if it's going to go in.
5 seconds left. Line of scrimmage. The 46-yard line.
That's unbelievable.
The hold will be, he's trying a 71-yard kick.
That's unbelievable.
This goes through Trump, I do a double gainer right out of the box. I've seen Dempsey kick one from 63 yards, the National Football League record. Florida State's not even putting anybody back. Coming with everybody. It's on the way. I don't believe it.
Oh!
Just short of the crossbar. He missed by a foot or two.
He could have made us. Oh, I don't believe it.
71-yard attempt.
Dead in the middle, about a yard short, and he's mad at himself. I think the game is over. The officials are heading for the tunnel.
The ball must be flat. We hit that.
How did he do that?
71-yard attempt, and so a difficult ending for both teams who fought every down of the way. Only to end in a tie. The first meeting between Florida State and Georgia since 1965. Kevin Butler came close. He'd have gone in the Hall of Fame if he hit that one, and he didn't miss it by much.
He's the Doug Flutie in the kicking world if he makes that one.
He is. So the final numbers are on the board. A 17-17 game. It's been a lot of years since we've had a tie. Florida Citrus Bowl.
Listen to these names. 1956, Juanita versus Missouri Valley, 6-6. 1954, East Texas State versus Arkansas State, 7-7. A lot better football game today.
Executive producer of NBC Sports, Michael Weissman, the coordinating producer of football on NBC, Ted Nathanson, our producer. Peter Rolf, our director, Richard Klein. Now for Bob Trumpy, this is Don Cricky, a tie game, 17-17. And let's go to NFL 84 in New York. More football coming.